Stadium. It's UK's Bowl Week. Kentucky takes on Iowa Saturday at the Citrus Bowl in Orlando. On your SportsEdge.com, Larry Vaught gave us 10 facts about Iowa. Here's a few to whet your appetite. Iowa has won 15 straight games against non-conference opponents, including 12 regular season non-conference victories and 3 bowl wins. Iowa leads the country with 24 interceptions and they're third in takeaways with 30. And the Hawkeyes have 3 wins over ranked opponents this season, including Indiana, Iowa State, and Penn State. Get the other 7 Vaught views at yoursportsedge.com. COVID continues to wreak havoc on the bowl game situations. We'd already seen the Gator Bowl have to bring in Rutgers to face Wake Forest after Texas A&M withdrew because of COVID. Now 3 more outright cancellations. Last Thursday, the Hawaii Bowl that would have seen Memphis take on Hawaii was canceled. Now the Fenway Bowl. In its first season, it was canceled because of COVID issues at Virginia. They had been scheduled to face SMU. And also the Military Bowl between ECU and Boston College has been canceled due to COVID. Update on hockey. After the COVID shutdowns of the NHL, the Predators will be back on the ice Wednesday night. Preds and Wild are in a virtual first place tie in the Central Division, and the Preds are on a 7-game win streak. Hear Coach John Calipari tonight at 5 p.m., followed by a special Citrus Bowl preview show with Coach Mark Stoops. Hear both on 100.9 FM, 1110 AM, WHVO. And it's the Coach Mike Vrabel show tonight at 6 on your home of the Titans, 106.5 WKDZ. That's it for your Monday. Visit WildcatLair.com or join us on Facebook. I'm Eddie Owen.
This is Alan Watts with your Ag Edge, inviting you to join me Monday through Friday at 5:30 a.m. for the WPKY Morning Ag Report. We check in daily with Caldwell County Agriculture Extension Agent Shane Bogle, get the latest from fellow farm broadcaster Max Armstrong, take a look at the latest livestock market reports, hear the latest edition of Traveling to Bluegrass, and check the opening grain market with Hopkins Elevator's Ben Westerfield. That's the Morning Ag Report from your Ag Edge Network on 103.3 FM and 1580 AM WPKY.
Attention Caldwell County residents that lost their homes during the December 10th tornado. UK Athletics is sending a charter bus to take a group of local fans to the home basketball game this Wednesday against the Missouri Tigers. UK will send a chartered bus to pick up a total of 54 tornado victims to take to the upcoming basketball game at Rupp Arena. Caldwell County residents that lost their homes are encouraged to send their name and phone number to WPKYOnline@gmail.com or text 270-522-1212 to get registered. 27 total winners will win a pair of tickets and be announced on Tuesday morning live during WPKY's Coffee Talk. Then on Wednesday at 1:45, the bus will fill up with all 54 fans and head to Lexington in time for tip-off and return after the game. Get your entry in now by sending your name and phone number to WPKYOnline@gmail.com or texting 270-522-1212.
Carrick. Isolation and quarantine time for those with COVID-19 or exposed in close contact now is 5 days instead of 10. CDC officials citing growing evidence people are most infectious 2 days before and 3 days after symptoms develop. The Omicron variant also playing a role in the change due to the sheer number of people infected and the impact of having so many isolate or quarantine, shutting down hospitals, airlines, and other businesses. Omicron already impacting airlines and staffing, Fox's Madison Alworth.
Yesterday, we saw the most cancellations, over 1,500 flights canceled. Airlines like United say the spread of Omicron has led to staffing issues. United telling Fox Business 50% of their passengers have arrived to their destination within 4 hours of their originally scheduled flight.
FlightAware.com reporting already more than 1,200 U.S. flights canceled today. America's listening to Fox News.
Serving Caldwell County since 1950, we're 1580, 103.3 WPKY Princeton. It's getting close to broadcast time. Caldwell Sports. Time to head live to the gym for a preview of tonight's action with the WPKY Sports Crew on 1580 103.3 WPKY. The WPKY Caldwell County pregame show is on the air. 1580 103.3 WPKY.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome back to the Cab tonight. The Caldwell County Tigers take the floor against the Arlington, Tennessee Tigers. That all part of the West Kentucky Hoops Classic as we round down the day one competition. Caldwell County will have the next to the last game on tap for tonight. We'll have the coverage here on WPKY. We'll kick it off with the Athletic Center pregame show. That's next here on your home for Tiger basketball, 1580, 103.3 WPKY.
Are you ready for a new adventure? Christian Care Communities. It's much more than a safe group of buildings for adults age 62 and older. It's about fellowship with others. At Christian Care Communities, our people are our most precious resource.
The people are so nice, and I've never had any trouble with my good old officials here either. When you come here, oh my goodness, you're just pampered. You don't have to get out and do any garden work.
We've made a lot of new friends and get to talk to them and see what's going on with them. So we really enjoy it. Have no regrets whatsoever. When you walk into your front door, your back door, when you move in, you've picked out everything that goes on the inside. Everything is new.
We are about exceeding expectations. Contact Jessica for a tour and to find out more about our move-in specials. Find us on Facebook at Christian Care Communities Hopkinsville and at ChristianCareCommunities.org.
You'll find over 30 years experience to work for you at U-Ride in Princeton. They are hometown proud and ready to serve your vehicle needs from start to finish, and they do it all safely. You'll find variety and quality vehicles along with on-the-lot financing. And of course, you can always apply online at uridesales.com. Stop by or call for an appointment today with one of their friendly sales staff at U-Ride on the Marion Road in Princeton, 270-365-3018. Hometown proud. Go Tigers!
Happy New Year from Pennyryle Electric. Did you know that outage information is right at your fingertips this winter? Pennyryle Electric works hard to ensure that the power stays on. But when something unforeseeable happens, they make it easy for you to stay informed. All you have to do is send a text to 85700. That's 85700. Save Pennyryle Electric in your contacts as 85700 for easy use in the future. May your season be warm and bright. Happy New Year from Pennyryle Electric.
This is what Kentucky basketball sounds like.
Got it! To raise...
Ball knocked away, stolen!
A ninth
fullback!
Championship banner.
The road to number nine lives here.
UK takes on Missouri Wednesday at 4:30. Hear all the coverage on WKDZRadio.com and
on 106.5 WKDZ.
Good luck, Tigers. Have a great season from Treasures Remembered.
We are back at the Community Activities Building as we are late in the day of day one of the West Kentucky Hoops Classic. Dennis Stevens and Bob Hayes here with you this afternoon. John Miller on control for us as well.
Still can't.
And Bob, Caldwell County comes into tonight's game playing some of their best basketball of the season as they reeled off three wins to win the Agri-Gold Christmas Classic.
Okay.
And Jabrion Spikes is just going berserk point-wise these days.
Caldwell County is really playing some lights-out basketball, Dennis, as you say, the last three games, especially winning that big tournament in Owensboro. And, you know, the competition gets a little stiffer here in the Hoops Classic, so we'll wait to see what Arlington brings to the table and how the Tigers counter, because we know nothing about Arlington.
Right now, Biggersville, Mississippi, and Robert E. Lee of Alabama in a pretty good game. Biggersville of Mississippi ahead by 12, 54-42 in the game right before our game tonight between Arlington and Caldwell County. This is the Athletic Center pregame show. The Athletic Center is your one-stop shop for all of your sports needs, whatever the sport. The Athletic Center has you covered from head to toe. They are a proud sponsor of Caldwell County Athletics, and they wish the Tigers and Lady Tigers a successful season. Bob, a little bit earlier today, we were here at the Cab as Caldwell County Lady Tigers took the floor against Hickman County. And the Lady Tigers, an impressive 22-point win over the Lady Falcons today, 62-40.
Lady Tigers, we watched them last Thursday play two games in Murray. Dennis, they got their first win against Mayfield, played Callaway County really strong in the day. Really in the third quarter blew the game open against Hickman County. Tomorrow's game against Lyon County will be a good match to see how much they have really improved and what they're getting to do and accomplish as the season goes on for them.
Yeah, Lyon County also had a game 62-40, but they were on the low side of that as a very strong Davis County team beat Lyon County's Lady Lions in the opener of day one of the West Kentucky Hoops Classic, 62-40. So that matchup tomorrow is going to be a good one. I think the Lady Tigers are kind of hitting their stride a little bit, if you will, after a very tough start, 0-6 and averaging between 25 and 30 turnovers a game. They have really turned things around and playing with what I like. We interviewed Briley Butts after the game. Her key word seemed to be confidence. They are playing with confidence. The players are doing their jobs with confidence, and it's starting to show on the court.
Certainly the Lady Tigers, I think, needed maybe 3 weeks to figure out what was going on, what roles they were going to have to play. And they've got good athletes on the team. It's just a simple matter of doing what you do best and keep doing that and not try to break out into something else. For instance, if you're a good defensive player, don't try to put up 25 shots a game. Do what your abilities let you do. And the other thing, something not to be made light of, we're a young basketball team engaged in some of this competition that last year we had basically, three seniors, four seniors, and Paris Gray. Some of the kids got to play last year as seventh graders and eighth graders and freshmen. They're coming into their own. That's the one good thing that can be said for the Lady Tigers. And tomorrow should be a good test. I thought Lyon played pretty well today. They just ran into a really cold spot late in the third quarter and the fourth quarter and couldn't get anything done.
Yeah, that's going to be a good game tomorrow. That will be our first game tomorrow on the air as the Lady Tigers and Lady Lions will square off at 3:30. We'll also have the Tigers and Lions tomorrow in a big showdown late in the West Kentucky Hoops Classic. That's a 6:30 tip-off tomorrow night featuring two of the premier players in the second region in Jabrion Spikes and Travis Perry.
And this place ought to be rocking and rolling tomorrow night. That's the warm-up game, if you will, for the
warm-up game, right.
For the final game tomorrow, which is the team from Montgomery, Alabama, Robert E. Lee, that we're seeing right now against Murray. Murray, I'd never seen them play this year. We don't get much of the paper anymore, hard to say how things are going, but Murray played pretty well.
Yeah, Murray had a big win in that game earlier today, so a pretty impressive game. We'll be capping off the activities here at the West Kentucky Hoops Classic. We're going to tell you more about that schedule as the broadcast goes along. Just about 3 minutes to go in this one. It's still a 10-point game with Biggersville, Mississippi in the lead right now. But looks like it might go down to 8, and does, as Robert E. Lee gets the bucket and the timeout. We're going to take a break ourselves. When we come back, we'll start taking a closer look at the Tigers as they get set for Arlington in the West Kentucky Hoops Classic right here on WPKY.
KFC Princeton, offering their amazing fried chicken and all the fix-its. You can dine in or call your order for pickup inside or use their convenient drive-thru. Your local KFC is located on the Marion Road in Princeton. Whether you enjoy a quick lunch or take dinner home or maybe take something to a friend in need, they're always ready to help. They're also looking for team members at KFC. Ask about becoming a member of their team. KFC on the Marion Road, where they appreciate your support and they are Princeton strong.
Trice Hughes has been serving Western Kentucky for over 60 years. Their experienced sales force, ASE-certified techs, and all the friendly folks at Trice Hughes have worked to become your family's exclusive automotive dealer, the home team that's kept our families safe on the road for generations. From work to play and everything in between, your home team has what you need. Stop by and drive the difference. Our home team, Trice Hughes, Highway 91 North in Princeton.
Because during this extremely difficult time in healthcare, many are afraid to go to the hospital or the doctor's office. Some folks may miss the opportunity to have Penny Royal Hospice help them through the most difficult of times. As a family member, you can refer your loved ones for the additional care needed at end of life without a hospital or doctor's visit. Penny Royal Hospice, it's about living to the fullest.
Get the care that you need to stay mentally and physically well from the convenience of your home. Health First Community Health Center is doing their part to help stop the spread. They're now offering telehealth services to keep you healthy at home. Scheduling a virtual visit with your medical or behavioral health provider is easy. All you need is a smartphone, tablet, or computer and internet access. Contact their office for an appointment at 877-667-7017. That's 877-667-7017. At Health First, your health is their first concern.
Chick-fil-A of Hopkinsville wants to salute the outstanding achievements of our area student-athletes. Each week, a student-athlete will be chosen based on academics, athletics, and achievements. Watch for the Chick-fil-A AAA Young Person of the Week at YourSportsEdge.com. Academics, athletics, and achievements at Chick-fil-A AAA Young Person of the Week at YourSportsEdge.com.
Herb Hayes Furniture and Mattress wishes all the Tiger athletes good luck this season. Go Tigers! Give it your all from Herb Hayes Furniture.
Welcome back to the Athletic Center pregame show. The Athletic Center is your one-stop shop for all of your sports needs. Whatever the sport, the Athletic Center has you covered from head to toe. Biggersville shooting free throws. And Bob, if they can convert these, this one will be over fairly quickly. Still 2:22. You can't blame Robert E. Lee for doing a little fouling here at the end of the game to try to have maybe a shot at it, but this one should not take much longer to get in the books. And then we are down to the Caldwell County Tigers and the Arlington Tigers in the next to last game this afternoon of the schedule of the West Kentucky Hoops Classic. Dennis Stevens along with Bob Hayes here to bring you the call on that game tonight. Bob, we have been so impressed with how Caldwell County has started to play as of late. They've won three in a row, of course, winning that Agrigold Christmas tournament, capping it off with a championship game win over McLean County at the Sports Center in Owensboro. They've won five of their last six, and Jabrion Spikes is just on an offensive tear right now with his scoring average up to 24.5 per game.
And Dennis, the good thing about that championship was against McLean County, Jabrion did not have his best game. He really had super games in the first round and the second round of that tournament. But that goes to show how together this team is, how tough they are. And you can't let your guard down against any of the five Caldwell County starters. They'll make you pay on the defensive end, on the offensive end. So, again, things are beginning to click with the men as they have with the Lady Tigers. I'm certainly looking for an interesting game tonight. And I'm looking for an interesting game tomorrow night. Don't want to get too far ahead of myself, but with Lyon County, obviously a neighboring rival. And just looking at the game in front of us, Dennis, the thought just ran through my mind. If you can't handle the ball, you don't need to be on the floor out here tonight in this game.
You're absolutely right. If you want to talk about speed and up-tempo games, this one is at the top of your list. Both of these teams rated highly in the respective states. Right now, Biggersville, Mississippi with the ball and a 10-point lead as they go under 2 minutes to play. Robert E. Lee trying to foul in the backcourt and finally get the foul called. But you're right, Bob. These kids, you got to be tired after this one. I'm kind of tired just watching them.
Exactly. They back tip and they double team you out of nowhere. Triple team you. If you just turn around, there are three guys on you.
Yeah, and that's a tip of the hat to the crew that has brought these teams in from five different states to take part in this West Kentucky Hoops Classic. We're going to talk about that more here in the Athletic Center pregame show. But, Bob, you mentioned the way Jabrion Spikes, maybe not his best offensive game in that championship game, but look at some of these scoring averages aside from Jabrion's that let you know Caldwell County is on an uptick. You're getting support from Dewey Riley at 8.6 a game. Both Whittington kids at 8 points a game, 7 points a game for Xavier Bumpus. Even D-Man Thompson almost at 5 points a game. So that's a lot of support points if Jabrion comes out and gets close to his average.
And I think Dewey had a great game in that final against McLean County. I don't have not yet talked to anybody who was at the game to give a recap of what went on, but Dewey was big in that game rebound-wise. I think he had 11 or 12, 13 points. And the Whittingtons, I know one of the Whittington boys led the team, 13 or 14 points, but I call that up here. That's double dribble.
Yeah, that one was not hard to call there, was it?
Fortunately, the referee saw it too, so. But and with that coming last week, they had Christmas break vacation. Sure, they got together two or three times during that period, ready to play. And I'm just wondering what we worked on in practice to make us even better, Dennis.
Well, I like the fact that sometimes on those nights that Jabrion may have an off night, and he's going to, you're going to see some tough competition. You got a strong schedule coming up and a busy schedule in January and the first half of February. So those kids that come in supporting roles, they can put in the 12, 13, 14, and maybe more like Colin Whittington, Carter Whittington, Dewey Riley, some of those kids, when they can start putting up those kind of points, and with the pressure defense that Caldwell County can put on a team, it's going to be a good team. I think they're in for a solid campaign this year, and you don't want to sleep on them come district or region time.
And the other thing, Dewey was not a starter last year, and as you work your way into being a starter and get more reps, get more minutes, you get better. And he's just a raw talent right now, and rebounds well, shoots well, and certainly is a big factor for what the Tigers can accomplish.
61-54 in this one as we are down to a minute 18 to go. Biggersville over Robert E. Lee of Alabama. Biggersville at the free throw line looking to ice this one.
The kid at the free throw line, Dennis, reminds me of probably an outstanding high school football quarterback.
Second free throw is up and good. 8-point lead now for Biggersville. Caldwell County in front of their dressing room ready to come out for their warm-ups. This is a whale of a tournament. Well, not necessarily a tournament. It's more of a showcase. West Kentucky Hoops Classic had started in some pretty humble beginnings, but has grown over the years to one of the premier showcases in West Kentucky around the Christmas time frame. And this year is no slouch at all as far as talent coming in here, because we've got kids that could conceivably play for state championships at the end of the season.
Absolutely. And it's just a good basketball situation here to be having it here in Princeton. A nice looking gymnasium, well lighted, and the tournament well run, great sponsors for the tournament. So it's just everything that you want, and I think it does put money in both the girls and the boys athletic program, maybe the basketball programs of those respective teams, but I don't know how widespread that might be.
I think it goes pretty deep, and a great job. We're going to talk about that a little bit more in the next segment. Teams back out on the floor, trying to get the last 1:18 played here before Caldwell County takes the floor against the Arlington Tigers. We're going to take a break, and when we come back, we're going to talk a little bit more about this West Kentucky Hoops Classic, a look at the schedule, and what we'll be covering both tonight and tomorrow. So all that's still to come right here on the Athletic Center pregame show on 1580, 103.3 WPKY.
Learn about your heart health with a simple scan. The Cardiology Clinic at Caldwell Medical Center features a highly trained team of heart health specialists and years of experience in cardiac health and wellness. Our specialists provide a wide range of cardiac-specific services, offering coronary artery calcium testing, stress test, echocardiograms, sleep studies, and more, all right here close to home. To schedule an appointment, visit caldwellmedical.com.
As a community-owned enterprise, the Princeton Electric Plant Board provides services to the people in the Princeton area. One of the services they provide is to make sure the lights are on over our fields and courts for our Caldwell County Tigers. From everyone at the Princeton Electric Plant Board, good luck to all the Caldwell County Tigers and hopes for a safe season. and a big electric roar to their Tigers, Preston Burrell, Addie Vinson, and Lily Horde.
Your local McDonald's wants you to know that they are ready to serve you for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Dine-in or the drive-thru is always open, and they offer curbside pickup service. To avoid the wait in the drive-thru, you can download the McDonald's app and try curbside pickup. Stop in soon and enjoy breakfast, lunch, or dinner at your local McDonald's. Proud to be a part of this community. McDonald's of Princeton, proud supporters of the Caldwell County Tigers.
Hey guys, it's Kelly Capps with Farmers Bank. Buying a home can be stressful, and I'm sure you have many questions like what's a good rate? What type of loan is right for me? I'm here to walk you through the process. Whether you're buying your first home, downsizing, or looking to upgrade, Farmers Bank has the options for you. We offer rural housing, VA loans, and so much more. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to give me a call, or you can apply online at yournxtbank.com. Farmers Bank and Trust Company, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
The WPKY News Edge is committed to keep you informed. Each weekday, they'll email you the top news and sports story of the day for free. No subscription fee. To sign up, click on the news tab at WPKYonline.com to sign up today. Sign up and receive these information updates for free to your email inbox. To sign up, click on the news tab at WPKYonline.com.
Good luck to all Tiger athletes from Bella Marie Boutique. Go Tigers!
Back to the cab as we are getting near the end of the game before the Caldwell County and Arlington matchup. Biggersville and Robert E. Lee. Biggersville with a 10-point lead, now down to 52 seconds left to go in that one. This is the Athletic Center pregame show. The Athletic Center is your one-stop shop for all of your sports needs. Bob Hayes, Dennis Stevens here, John Miller on controls for us tonight. Bob, taking a look at this West Kentucky Hoops Classic, you're getting teams in here from not only Kentucky, but also Missouri, Mississippi, Alabama, and Tennessee. So you're really starting to make it a showcase event and not just something to put a few teams on the court around Christmas. This is one where teams are actually starting to call and want to play in this thing now.
And really, that's a credit to Torrey and how he's organized this tournament the last several years. It makes his job a lot easier now, not having to go out and recruit as heavily as he once did, and bringing in some of these teams want to come back, having been to Princeton at least on one occasion. So that speaks well for the tournament. So Dennis, looks like with 27 seconds, we will have three more timeouts and four trips to the free throw line. So.
It's shaping up that way. There's no quit, obviously, in Robert E. Lee out of Alabama. But this one is one of those you can go ahead and start turning the lights out if they're not already out anyway. Biggersville with a good showing. A little better than Biggersville's girls team. A real struggle today with Henderson County. Henderson won the game before this one 60-11 and shut out Biggersville's girls in the second half.
Henderson County is
31-0.
Is reputed to be loaded, Dennis, but I have not seen them play. But, obviously, I don't know how strong Biggersville's ladies are, just what their record is.
Well, I think they had six wins coming into today. Oh, they're a single-A school, but wins. But they just got manhandled by the press of Henderson County. And, you know, we never go out on a limb in girls basketball around here saying if you're going to win the region, you're going to go through Henderson County. And that's looking like it's more true than ever this season.
Absolutely. It's either Henderson or one of the Hopkinsville schools, Christian County, or Madisonville normally.
Yeah, Madisonville, another good team with Cameron LaGrange back from that knee injury and playing outstanding basketball again this season. 26 seconds left. Still a 10-point lead for Biggersville in this one. But, Bob, going back to talking about this West Kentucky Hoops Classic, a lot of high-quality, high-caliber teams in it. And if you want to see some upscale, upbeat, up-tempo basketball, this is the place to be. You've got another day to come tomorrow. If you missed today, had to get the family back home from their Christmas visits, and you're looking for something to do tomorrow, want to come back, grab a chair back, and just watch a lot of basketball, $8. We'll get you your fill of basketball tomorrow, and plus concessions available here at the cab.
What does $8 get you, Dennis? Two games or four games?
That is how many games are on tap tomorrow night. I have never taken the time to count them, Bob. You're looking at 7 games on tap tomorrow for $8. So a little over $1 a game. You can come and spend the day at the cab and see some great basketball.
And the game is over.
Plus, another thing that Torrey and his crew do, each one of these games, 14 games overall, there's a most valuable player for each team in each game. So that's coming up here for these two schools. Earlier today, Katie Smiley picked it up in a double-double in the win for the Lady Tigers over Hickman County. But you also had some players. You had Paris Gray. Paris Gray could have taken the award. You had
Riley Butts
easily could have taken it with 18 points and the defensive pressure that she put out on the floor today. So
I found out who number 11 was, Dennis.
Go ahead.
Jada Alexander.
Okay. We'll need to put that on our card.
Hopefully, yeah. We better write that down because tomorrow is a new day with my mind. So.
Okay, Jada Alexander, we will get that on the roster card during our next break.
Coach Mitchell said he would dress her the rest of the season. So,
teams getting their most valuable players done, then they'll put, I think it's 15 minutes back on the board in between games here for the players to warm up. But crowd starting to pack in. This thing, the lower levels are, what would you say, Bob, at least 50% full on both sides right now.
Yes, and the level across from us, you can see teams up there. The two teams that play next are going to watch at least the first half of this game.
So Caldwell County coming out on the floor. They will be followed by Arlington, both the teams, the Tigers tonight. So Caldwell County Tigers and Arlington Tigers, Arlington 6-3 on the year. They come out of Shelby County, which is in the very southwest corner of Tennessee near the Memphis area. So you know they're playing some good schools around that area, some big talent. And to be 6-3, they've got a size advantage over Caldwell. We know that going in. They carry a roster with a couple of 6'5 kids, 6'4, 6'3, a couple of 6'3s. So a lot of height on the Arlington team. We don't know if that's their starters, any of those kids, or if they come off the bench or play any at all. But just looking at the roster, size is on the side of Arlington tonight.
Just looking at the Tigers, I think they've got a couple, three more players dressed tonight. I noticed a little spark plug that we see in the JV game is in uniform.
Right.
So we hopefully we'll have enough names here if they do get in.
We'll get those. If not, we'll certainly talk with Coach K after the ball game here tonight. 11 minutes still on the clock. We'll take our last break here, and when we come back, we'll talk more specifically about the Caldwell County Tigers, what to expect tonight, and what Coach K is looking for out of his team as they'll face a tough Arlington team and a tough Lyon County team here in the West Kentucky Hoops Classic on WPKY.
Are you ready for a new adventure? Christian Care Communities. It's much more than a safe group of buildings for adults age 62 and older. It's about fellowship with others. At Christian Care Communities, our people are our most precious resource.
The people are so nice, and I've never had any trouble with my good old officials here either. When you come here, oh my goodness, you're just pampered. You don't have to get out and do any garden work.
We've made a lot of new friends and get to talk to them and see what's going on with them. So we really enjoy it. I have no regrets whatsoever. When you walk into your front door, your back door, when you move in, you've picked out everything that goes in the inside. Everything is new.
We are about exceeding expectations. Contact Jessica for a tour and to find out more about our move-in specials. Find us on Facebook at Christian Care Communities Hopkinsville and at ChristianCareCommunities.org.
Fortner Gas Company has been serving the propane needs of Western Kentucky for 70 years. You'll find offices in Princeton and Katy's. They're your local and family-owned propane supplier. Browse their website to discover the many services and products available. You can shop in person or online, and they can answer any and all questions in person or on the phone. If they're already your propane supplier, they say thank you. If they're not, they would love to be. Fortner Gas Company, a family tradition of service since 1951.
Enjoy your favorite Mexican food at La Potosina Mexican Restaurant. They're open 7 days a week from 11 a.m. until 9 p.m., offering up all your favorite authentic Mexican dishes for lunch and dinner. Now you pair your favorite meal with your favorite margarita. Enjoy dining in or call in for carryout. Call 270-365-3848 to place your order. They appreciate your business and are ready to serve you in a safe atmosphere. That's La Potosina Mexican Restaurant.
Princeton and Marion.
With YourSportsEdge.com, you get more coverage of your favorite teams, athletes, and sports.
Lets me know the student as a whole person.
With no page limits or subscription fees ever.
It means exposure for the local high school athletes.
A new look and a new feel, no matter where you are.
Even if I'm out of town, I have it on my phone.
It's always available right at your fingertips.
Round-the-clock coverage of local athletes.
High school sports coverage the way it's supposed to be.
I love what they did with the website.
Download the free app now.
YourSportsEdge.com.
Raider Auction Company is excited to cheer on all the Tiger athletes this season. Go Tigers from Raider Auction Company.
Back to the Cav as we get in our last segment here on the Athletic Center pregame show. The Athletic Center, your one-stop shop for all of your sports needs. Whatever the sport, the Athletic Center has you covered from head to toe. Bob, we know the key players for Caldwell County. You've got the Whittingtons that have to take care of the basketball, not have a lot of turnovers. You've got Dewey Riley that's coming on in his own as far as scoring points. You've got Jabrion Spikes just having a phenomenal first start of the season here for Caldwell County. But you've also got some key role players. You've got the Isaiah Joiners, Xavier Bumpus, Blake Vivarette, D-Man Thompson, even Elijah Shaheen and Camden Wolford. You go down to those kids, you're not necessarily looking for double figures, but you're looking for kids to come in, play anywhere from 2 to 8, maybe 9 minutes of basketball, not turn the ball over, maybe get a couple of rebounds, a bucket here and there, or a free throw, know their roles. And when they do that, this team led by Jabrion and the other starters, if they do their jobs keeping the turnovers down, this is a dangerous team.
Absolutely. And those players that you mentioned, Xavier can go off just instantly from three-point land and turn a game around. You got D-Man who's going to rebound with anybody in this end of the state, his size and strength, and just all kinds of and then you've got the human highlight reel, Blake Vivarette, who does everything so effortlessly.
Well, those kids are going to be fun to watch this season. We're looking forward to tonight as well as a big one against the big rival Lyon County tomorrow night. That's a 6:30 contest as well for Caldwell County. Let's take a look now at tonight's injury report brought to you by Caldwell Medical Center. Caldwell Medical Associates Orthopedic Clinic is your one-stop shop for all of your orthopedic care to get you back out on the field or on the court. Our skilled team of providers have the experience and knowledge to treat and diagnose a wide range of orthopedic services. Caldwell Medical Associates is a proud sponsor of Caldwell County Athletics, and they wish the Tigers well this season.
And as far as any injury, we know of no such thing for the Tigers. Everybody healthy, everybody ready to play.
And that's great to hear as we round out December and get into the district games and some of the regular rivalries. 5.5 minutes before we tip this one off. We also want to mention that well, I had the wrong notepad out here, Bob. We'll just carry on as we were. I had a 1-9, but it was the wrong one. Caldwell County on the floor warming up right now, as is Arlington. The Tigers out of Arlington, Tennessee, down around Memphis, out on the floor as both teams get set to get this one underway. We'll take our last break, and when we come back, we'll have the starting lineups and the opening tip, all of that still to come right here on 1580, 103.3 WPKY.
Learn about your heart health with a simple scan. The Cardiology Clinic at Caldwell Medical Center features a highly trained team of heart health specialists and years of experience in cardiac health and wellness. Our specialists provide a wide range of cardiac-specific services, offering coronary artery calcium testing, stress test, echocardiograms, sleep studies, and more, all right here close to home. To schedule an appointment, visit CaldwellMedical.com.
Hello, this is Brad Harrelson with First Southern National Bank. There is little doubt that many are facing financial hardships in our country today. The statistics can be startling to look at, with as many as 70% of Americans having less than $1,000 saved for emergencies. While it can be easy to point fingers, the truth of the matter is that many folks lack the basic financial knowledge to avoid these pitfalls. To meet this need, First Southern has provided financial literacy resources so that the people of our communities can be better equipped to face the financial challenges life throws their way. We invite you to explore the Financial Literacy Resource Center at fsmb.net. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Heather Amin would like to wish the Tigers all the best of luck this year. Go Tigers!
And we are back to the cab as we get set for Caldwell County and Arlington in the next to last game of the West Kentucky Hoops Classic Day 1. And Bob, maybe a little bit of a correction to the injury report. We have noticed that Blake Vivarette not dressed for tonight's basketball game.
Definitely in street clothes, so we hadn't heard anything coming from the bench or from any of the players as to what may be his ailment.
He has nursed a little bit of an ankle injury early in the season, so we wonder if that's come up. If the Tigers will be without the services, obviously, tonight of Blake Vivarette. Bob, one thing before we start getting into some of our other things that we have lined up here. I want to remind everybody that UK is doing something just absolutely phenomenal for our community that was hit so hard by the tornadoes on December 10th. They are giving away two tickets to 27 couples, 54 tickets total, to take a bus ride tomorrow or Wednesday to the Kentucky-Missouri game at Rupp Arena. You'll get to stand. I think it's in the eruption zone since the kids are going home for the Christmas break, where the band usually sits. They will be standing room tickets, but great, great generosity from the University of Kentucky. They're going to bring a bus to Princeton. This is for Princeton residents only, or Caldwell County residents only, and only those that lost their homes in the tornado. The charter bus will be leaving around 1:45 to make the trip to Lexington, and then the bus will bring everybody back after the game. So contact the radio station. Let's see, there's two ways. You can email wpkyonline@gmail.com or text your information to 270-522-1212. And
a nice gesture. Really nice gesture.
Seats on that bus for the UK-Missouri game on Wednesday. And we'd love for some folks in our area to get a chance to go to a UK game, maybe get their mind off of what happened just a little over a couple of weeks ago here in Princeton. A minute 35 before we start this one off, I want to remind everybody the tip-off tonight is brought to you by Travis Construction and Concrete. They are your guys for all of your construction concrete needs, as well as driveways, porches, foundations, basement walls, decorative concrete, remodels, and more. Good luck, Tigers and Lady Tigers. And here's to building a successful year from Travis Construction and Concrete.
And, Dennis, while we've got some time before the starters are introduced, the first quarter tonight brought to us by Cozy Living Interiors and Boutique, located next to the bowling alley here in Princeton. Beautiful furniture, baby furniture, gifts and registry, home decor, boutique clothes and accessories. Stop and see what Pam has. It's post-Christmas. Obviously should be some sales about to be made. Cozy Living, everything a home should be.
Bob, it's going to be a game where Caldwell County has to take care of the basketball, and they're going to have to rebound well, because you look at the size that Arlington brings in, 2.65 kids, a 6'4 kid, 2.63 kids. So it's going to be a matter. You've got to block out on the boards and limit Arlington to one shot.
Absolutely. It's imperative that we limit our turnovers.
R.J. White, the first starter, and I'll give these starters over to Bob.
Guard is 6'3", junior number one, Andrew Ellis.
Andrew Ellis, the second Tiger from Arlington.
Sophomore number 11, Carl Burrows,
junior.
6'1", junior, number 14, Aiden Moskovitz.
Number 14, Aiden Moskovitz. And 35 is Mo Nazer.
And Nazer is one of the 6'5 kids.
And the Tigers, it's about to be introduced. Number two, Xavier Bumpus, getting start tonight. Number four, Xavier Spikes, being introduced. Carter Whittington out. Colin Whittington coming out. And Dewey Riley, the last Tiger to be introduced.
Crowd really starting to flow in for this one and the nightcap tonight.
I think the across from us lower section is now two-thirds full, maybe even more than that.
Yeah, the chair back seats are at a premium on that side of the floor. Dewey Riley is going to jump against Mo Nazar. Nazar, as we said, at 6'5", and Caldwell County is going to control the tip. As it is number five, Carter Whittington with the basketball. Man-to-man pressure from Arlington out of the gate. Spikes into the corner. Colin Whittington drives back out to Spikes. Spikes sizes up Nazar, driving, kicks it back out. Xavier Bumpus short on the three. Rebound, Spikes misses the inside shot. Carter Whittington gets the rebound, goes up, has it blocked, gets it back, kicks it back out to his brother Colin. Colin drives in left side, wants to dump it down to Riley. Riley's going to get called for steps or 3 seconds in the lane. Turnover Caldwell County, but a nice job by Caldwell's kids to have three shots at the basket that possession.
And they're all decent. Dewey finally put the ball in, but just after he had walked.
Underneath it goes and out of bounds. Turnover Arlington.
Turnovers even now at one apiece.
Just underway here in the first quarter. No score from the Cab. Carter Whittington drives up against Moskowitz. Colin now over to Riley. Riley gives it up to Carter. Tries to go a baseline pass to Spikes. Hit the baseline across, and it's out of bounds. Two trips, two turnovers for Caldwell County. Bringing it up at the point is going to be Aiden Moskowitz, number 14. Moskowitz looks around to number 11, Burroughs. Burroughs wants to drive, pulls up from the elbow, jumper is good. Burroughs puts Arlington on the board first, 2-0. Spikes with the basketball now, guarded by Andrew Ellis. Spikes drives, Euro step, left hand off the glass, and good. Jabrion Spikes. His first two of hopefully many tonight, and it's 2-2.
Great move, his signature move.
Over to Arlington's number zero. That's R.J. White. Back out to Moskowitz. Goes off a screen, into the corner to Ellis. Ellis wanted to drive, cut off nicely by Colin Whittington. Over to White. White kicks it back out. They'll start the offense again. Ellis. Looking to drive, shot up, no good. Two-shot foul. Let's see who commits that one. Colin Whittington with the foul. And they are giving free throws to Andrew Ellis.
First trip to the free throw line for either team tonight, Andrew Ellis.
First free throw is good. Try to pull this up and see what they shoot from the line on the season. Off the front of the rim, no good, and that stat not included in theirs on Max Preps. 3-2 as we go under 6 minutes to play in the first quarter. Spikes off a screen from Riley, drives, left hand, no good, rebound Arlington. Arlington with numbers back. Nice defensive play by Whittington to get back and get a hand on the ball. There's going to be a tie-up underneath as Riley gets down on it with White. Possession arrow stays with Arlington. They'll take it out of bounds behind their own basket. In it comes Moskowitz, head fake from the free throw line. Good. Got his defender in the air and converted on the short jumper. 5-3 Arlington. Spikes up court. Still man-to-man pressure. Hand off to Carter Whittington. They'll work it into the corner. Nice cut through by Carter Whittington, nice feed inside from his brother Colin. Misses the shot, but he'll go to the free throw line for a couple of Goodwin Insurance free throws. Moskowitz with the foul. Nice give and go and nice screen out front.
And Carter thought he was going to get it blocked right away. If it had gone right up immediately, nobody was going to contest the shot.
Whittington misses his first. Really well-run play by Caldwell County. Whittington misses both. Rebound down to Ellis. Ellis, outlet pass to White. Three is good from the right wing. Early 8-2 lead for Arlington. D-man Thompson off the bench. He'll come in at the next opportunity. Spikes at the point for Caldwell County, guarded by R.J. White. To Riley. Riley, top of the key, gets it over Whittington. Whittington pulls it around, back to Spikes. Spikes calling for a screen out front, wants to drive, pulls back, three on the way, off the mark. Rebound Arlington, but a nice heads-up steal on a back tap. Xavi Bumpus drives, shots blocked, but a lot of contact, and he'll go to the free throw line for two. And clock still running. I think they'll want to stop that. And they're going to address the clock situation. It had a little flicker to it. And Bob, I think it was around 4:30 left to go in the first quarter. We'll see where they reset this to.
Did you see who the foul was on, Dennis?
No, it flickered about the time they put that up, as it's still doing. Showing 4:42 now, but I'm pretty sure it was considerably less than that. They're going to leave it with the 4:42. Yeah. As Xavier Bumpus will go up to the line.
Somebody picked up their second foul that's not been listed yet.
Free throw is good. Our free throw is sponsored by Goodwin Insurance, your locally owned independent insurance agency capable of handling all of your insurance needs. Contact Goodwin Insurance for a free quote. D-man Thompson into the ball game for Caldwell County as Carter Whittington comes out for a breather. 8-3 Arlington. Second free throw by Bumpus is good. Lead down to four as Moskowitz brings it across the timeline for Arlington. To Ellis, top of the key. Hands off to Moskowitz. Long three, top of the key, off the back of the rim, no good. Great block out by Dewey Riley. He had big Mo Nasser on his back. Nasser at 6'5". Bumpus to Whittington. Whittington pulls up free throw line, kicks it back to Bumpus. No good on the shot. Rebound Arlington. Long outlet pass to White. White for a three. No good. Jabrion Spikes with the basketball as we go under 4 minutes to play in the first quarter. Spikes, nice dribbling. Shot up off the glass. No good, but a foul. Are they going to call that one on the floor, Bob, I think?
Two fouls on 14, Moskowitz, second,
team third. Two fouls on Moskowitz. Three on Arlington. Still not sure who that other foul is on, Bob. They're not posting it on the board.
No, they've missed it.
Colin Whittington with the basketball on the right wing. Lob inside looking for Riley. That one tipped away. And it's Ellis coming down with it. Ellis. Arlington works it down into the corner. Back out into the game is number 12, V.J. Simmons. Simmons with the basketball. He'll put up a long three and good from the left wing. V.J. Simmons and the lead at 7 for Arlington. Bumpus gets it to Spikes. Spikes looks it over. Riley on the screen. Spikes thought about pulling it back out, gives it to D-man Thompson, top of the key, three, no good. Nasser with the rebound for Arlington. Nasser gives it up to Simmons. Simmons running the point now for Arlington. Man-to-man pressure still by Caldwell County. They've been in man-to-man the entire game. Lob looking for Nasser is picked off by Spikes. Spikes drives, shot up off the glass and in. Farmers Bank shot, Jabrion Spikes. Farmers Bank and Trust Company, home of the Tiger debit card, the card that gives back to future athletes of Caldwell County. On the other end, it's White. Long three partially blocked by Bumpus. Thompson comes up with it. They work it down court. Bumpus from the corner drives baseline, kicks it opposite corner to Whittington. Back to Bumpus. Bumpus to Whittington again from the corner. Three is good. Little Caesars Pizza, three-pointer. Colin Whittington, Little Caesars Pizza, home of the $5 hot and ready. 11-9, just over 2 minutes to play in the first quarter. Arlington with the two-point lead and the basketball. It's Burroughs to Nasser. Nasser looking down low. It's kicked out. Three on the way. No good from Simmons. Rebound, though, comes down to White. Back to Ellis. Ellis looks it over. Spikes on him. Ellis, free throw line high. No good. Nasser with the rebound goes back up, and Spikes, I think, got the reach-in foul, Bob.
I think they got him.
Howard County foul number four, Spikes, his first, team second.
Two team fouls on Caldwell County, first on Jabrion. That puts Mo Nasser at the free throw line. Free throw off the front of the rim, short. Carter Whittington in. And coming out is going to be Dewey Riley. Riley, very good first quarter. Nasser, second free throw is good. Lead at three now for Arlington. Substitutes coming in for the Arlington Tigers. Number 32 is Aiden Ludwig. Carter Whittington at the point. Inside out very quickly to Colin Whittington. Cowell working the ball around well. Colin Whittington for three. No good. Spikes high for the rebound. Back up and in. Spikes, great position underneath. And an easy bucket makes it 12-11. 1:20 left in the first quarter. Carter Whittington really putting the pressure outside on Simmons. Simmons pass altered. And Caldwell County's Thompson comes away with a steal, but he has it stolen away. And then Arlington turns around, steps on the baseline, and Simmons turns it back over to Caldwell County. So three turnovers in the span of about 2 seconds, it seemed like, Bob.
Arlington with six now, Caldwell County with three. Yes, it was a turnover, half a second each in there.
1 minute left in the first quarter. Colin Whittington drives off the glass and good. Powell with the lead now at 13-12. Colin Whittington guarding the point. At the point is Simmons. Simmons off his knee, able to regain it. Over to Ellis, to White. Now they'll get it to Burroughs. To Simmons, drives the lane, misses. Ludwig puts the ball back up, no good. Good position there by D-man Thompson. I don't think they're going to call Ludwig over the back.
Arlington fouls number 32. His first, team
four. Ludwig picks up the foul. They're still only showing three team fouls, but it is four team fouls on Arlington. 31 seconds left in the quarter. See if Caldwell County goes for the last shot. Man-to-man pressure. Arlington picks up three-quarter court. Caldwell County gets it across. D-man Thompson to Carter Whittington. Over to Colin, top of the key, to Bumpus. Bumpus, spin move, and a blocking foul called on Arlington. Bob also in the ball game is number 12, first time tonight, Jack Englebright. R.J. White with the foul. Five team fouls on Arlington here in the first quarter. Underneath it goes Thompson. Thompson has it blocked, gets it back, goes back up and in. Caldwell County now with a three-point lead. Arlington quickly down court, has it knocked away, goes out of bounds. Caldwell basketball with 1.3 seconds on the clock. A catch and heave on the way. Whoever catches this for Caldwell County comes into Whittington. Baseball throw down the court, no good. After one quarter of play, it's Caldwell County 15, Arlington 12. Back after this on WPKY.
Life is filled with moments. Moments we share with those we love, worry about, and strive to protect the most.
At Woodman Life, we provide life insurance and retirement products to help protect you and your family so that you can enjoy all the moments to come.
This is Josh Ray, your local Woodman Life agent. Come see us at 1009 West Main Street or give us a call at 365-6111.
Certain eligibility and age restrictions apply. Woodman of the World Life Insurance Society, Omaha, Nebraska.
Happy New Year from Pennyryle Electric. Did you know that outage information is right at your fingertips this winter? Pennyryle Electric works hard to ensure that the power stays on. But when something unforeseeable happens, they make it easy for you to stay informed. All you have to do is send a text to 85700. That's 85700. Save Pennyryle Electric in your contacts as 85700 for easy use in the future. May your season be warm and bright. Happy New Year from Pennyryle Electric.
Welcome back to the cab. Second quarter coming up, brought to us by Cozy Living Interiors and Boutique. Caldwell County will inbound it, bring it from half court. And for the call, Dennis Stevens.
Thank you, Bob. On the floor right now, Carter Whittington, Bumpus, Thompson, Englebright, and Spikes. Englebright, pass picked off at midcourt. It's Arlington back the other way. Spin move underneath, up and in is R.J. White. Turnover led to points for Arlington out of the break. 15-14, just underway in the second quarter. 1-2-2 zone by Arlington. Back out to Spikes. Spikes, right wing to Englebright for three from the baseline. No good. Ludwig with the rebound. Gets it up to Moskowitz. Moskowitz back with it now at the point. Tries to drive down the lane. Up, no good. Traveled on the way.
Eight turnovers for Arlington.
Really good weak side help on that drive from Caldwell County across the lane. Looked like Thompson came over and got in the way. Carter Whittington gets it across to Bumpus, back to Whittington. 1-2-2 zone. They'll flatten it out to a 3-2. They'll really bring the middle guy out high on the top. Spikes in the middle, goes in. Some contact, gets his own rebound, back up, no good. And Arlington fighting amongst themselves for the rebound, almost went out of bounds. White keeps it. He'll get it back top of the key. Looking for Simmons on the curl. Instead, Ludwig's going to come out for the pick. White wants to drive on Thompson. Shot up, no good. D-man going to get called for the push.
Caldwell County foul number 24, Demetrius Thompson, his first, team third.
Three team fouls now on Caldwell County here in the first half. First on Thompson. And, Bob, they're going to make that a shooting foul. I thought they might call that one on
the floor. Yeah. I mean, he was headed for the shot.
On the floor, yeah. Free throw up. No good for R.J. White. Checking in now, big kid Luke McBride. See what McBride's size is on his. 6'5", sophomore.
Is that, yeah, there's
6'4 and 6'5 in the game right now for Arlington.
Ludwig's a big old boy.
Second free throw for White. Rattles out. Battle for the rebound. Dewey Riley right in between the two big kids. Tie up is called. Possession arrow is going to keep it with Arlington. You're listening to Tiger Basketball on WPKY Princeton. 6:26 left to go in the first half. 15-14 Caldwell County. Ludwig takes the inbounds pass, dribbles, baby hook, partially blocked, gets his own rebound up and in high off the glass. Aiden Ludwig. Jabrion Spikes now at the point with the basketball for Caldwell County, trailing by one with 6 minutes left to go in the second quarter. Spikes in the lane, jumper up and in. Spikes really elevating that jumper from short range.
You just can't block him when he gets that kind of lift.
Moskowitz to Simmons. Simmons stopped at the top of the key. He'll get it back out at the logo, guarded by Colin Whittington. Simmons, drive, runner, up, and no good. Riley with the strong rebound, gives it to Bumpus. Xavier across half court, behind the back, guarded by Simmons, over to Whittington. 3-2 zone, they'll work it inside. Riley off the glass, no good. Goes up, gets his own rebound, tied up. And we'll see if a foul on the play. I think instead of a tie-up, they're going to call Ludwig.
Yeah, they got him for his second foul.
Six-team foul on Arlington, second on Ludwig. That gets Nasser back off the bench for Arlington. Caldwell to inbound. Spikes gives it to Whittington. Carter in the corner, looking underneath the Spikes. Spikes up and under. No good. Had his own rebound. Had it knocked away from behind, out of bounds. It'll stay Caldwell Tiger basketball.
Jabrion with 8 points here in the game on 4 field goals.
Jabrion giving up a few inches height-wise, but man, he is really going up strong. Three by Whittington, no good. Rebound falls down to Bumpus. Bumpus to Carter in the corner, drives baseline, dump off Spikes, off the glass and in. Spikes found a seam between Moskovitz and Big McBride, put it in. 19-16 Tigers, 4:50 left to go in the first half. Outside to White. White gets a screen from McBride. McBride posted up the pick and roll. Instead, they go to Moskovitz on the left wing. Underneath to Nasser. Nasser back to Moskovitz. Runner in the lane, up and in off the glass. All three kids at 6'5 have been in for Arlington. Caldwell County still doing a very good job on the board as Spikes comes across with the Tigers up by one. Carter Whittington wanting to go, and a timeout called by Coach K. It's a 30-second timeout. We'll take a quick break and be back. Tigers by one with 4:17 left in the first half.
Trice Hughes has been serving Western Kentucky for over 60 years. Their experienced sales force, ASE certified techs, and all the friendly folks at Trice Hughes have worked to become your family's exclusive automotive dealer. The home team that's kept our family safe on the road for generations. From work to play and everything in between, your home team has what you need. Stop by and drive the difference. Our home team, Trice Hughes, Highway 91 North in Princeton.
Welcome back to the Cab. 4 minutes, 17 seconds to play in the second quarter. Caldwell County to inbound it. Jay Brown to take it out of bounds. And for the call, my friend Dennis Stevens.
Thank you, Bob. Spikes gets it into Whittington, who will toss it to another Whittington. They play pitch and catch. Now it's Collin at the top of the key over to Carter. 2-3 zone and a big back line for Arlington. Whittington to the left side now. Bumpus in the corner. Back to Collin Whittington. Spikes will come out and get it. He'll try a three left wing. No good. Rebound falls into the hands of Simmons for Arlington Tigers. As it knocked away, ball loose on the floor, diving for it, and picked up by Collin Whittington. About six players touched the basketball. It finally came into the hands of Collin Whittington into the corner. Bumpus will try a three off the back of the rim. No good. It's Moskovitz on the rebound for Arlington. Underneath it goes to McBride, back out to Moskovitz. Wants to drive baseline. Push going to be called on Carter Whittington.
Caldwell County fouls number 5, Carter Whittington. His first team fourth.
First foul on Whittington. Nasser with the basketball on the inbounds pass. Try to spin move on Thompson. Now gets it back. Misses the little bunny underneath and then commits the frustration foul as Spikes had nice position and picked up the rebound.
Arlington foul number 35,
Mo Nasser.
That is his second.
Mo Nasser with the foul, his first. And that'll put Spikes at the line for Caldwell County. One in the bonus. Free throw does fall. I thought that one was going to come off hard, Bob, but found a way to stay on and go in.
It looked hard from here. It looked like if it hit the iron, it wasn't going to be able to bounce in, but it did.
So Jabrion Spikes with the Goodwin Insurance free throw. Looking for a little towel to wipe up some moisture.
I just used my shirt, Dennis.
Spike steps back up to the line for the bonus. Jabrion really improving on the free throws. This one off the mark, though. Chased down by McBride. McBride finds a way to get it back to Moskowitz. Just over 3 minutes left in the first half. Caldwell County nursing a two-point lead. Moskowitz guarded closely over to number 11. That's Burroughs with the three from the left wing. And that puts Arlington back in front. Now 21-20. This one's been close throughout. I think Arlington had an eight-point lead at one point. Carter Whittington looks over the 1-2-2 zone. Little pitch and catch back and forth out front. Now they'll go down into the corner to Spikes now inside the lane. Has his pass over to Thompson picked off. Burroughs, one-hand pass to Simmons, up and in off the left glass. 3-point lead now and a 5-0 run for Arlington. Colin Whittington well out front, looking over the zone. Caldwell spacing the ball well. Down to Joyner. Joyner gets it in to Bumpus, goes up, almost made the shot. It would have been a miraculous shot, but rims off. Jabrion instead will go to the free throw line for a couple of Goodwin Insurance free throws. Big McBride with his first. And Jabrion at the line. First one off the back of the rim. Ludwig in for McBride. White in for Simmons. Spike's second try. Again off the back of the rim. Big rebound, D-man Thompson. Off the glass, no good. Spikes with the board and the bucket as he went back up strong. Put it over the front of the rim and in. 1-point lead, just under 2 minutes now to go in the first half. R.J. White at the point. Has it knocked away by Isaiah Joyner. And a timeout call. Arlington didn't like the pressure. Coaching staff calls a timeout. And we'll take a timeout along with them. 23-22 Arlington, back after this.
Your local McDonald's wants you to know that they are ready to serve you for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Dine-in or the drive-thru is always open, and they offer curbside pickup service. To avoid the wait in the drive-thru, you can download the McDonald's app and try curbside pickup. Stop in soon and enjoy breakfast, lunch, or dinner at your local McDonald's. Proud to be a part of this community. McDonald's of Princeton, proud supporters of the Caldwell County Tigers.
Cozy Living Interior and Boutique, cheering on all Tiger athletes.
We're back to the cab. Arlington will inbound the ball at midcourt. Meanwhile, the referees are getting some moisture off the floor here in front of the Tiger bench. And for the call here are the final 1 minute 46 seconds, my friend Dennis Stevens.
Thank you, Bob. Moskowitz at the point to Burroughs. Burroughs to Ellis. Ellis working against Spikes, gives it back up Moskowitz. He'll try a three, left side, good. Caldwell County went under the screen and Moskowitz made them pay. 26-22, Arlington. 1-2-2 zone, Caldwell gets it inside. Spikes kicks it out. Now baseline drive by Colin Whittington is cut off. He'll find Joyner. Joyner to Spikes. Spikes pulls it out near the logo, left side. Whittington back to Joyner. Over to Spikes now. Spikes calling for Joyner for the screen. Into the corner, D-man Thompson turned down the three. Back to Joyner. Caldwell very patient against this 2-3 zone now. Colin Whittington to his brother Carter. 50 seconds left on the clock. Back to Colin. Colin thought about the long three. Instead pulls it back. Gives it up to Carter. Over to Colin. Inside Spikes. 12-footer off the side of the rim. No good. Rebound Arlington. They'll want to run. It is Burroughs back the other way. Spin move. Runner off the glass. No good. Isaiah Joyner with a nice rebound. Back over to Whittington. Whittington drives. Carter up and in off the glass. 26-24. Caldwell County full court pressure. Now they'll go back, pick up at half court. Joyner on Burroughs. Burroughs drive, dumped down Ludwig, misses the short one. Back out at the buzzer, does not go. And we'll go to the locker room at the half. It's Arlington 26, Caldwell County 24. Stay tuned. We'll be back with the Travis Construction and Concrete Halftime Show next on WPKY.
Get the care that you need to stay mentally and physically well from the convenience of your home. Health First Community Health Center is doing their part to help stop the spread. They're now offering telehealth services to keep you healthy at home. Scheduling a virtual visit with your medical or behavioral health provider is easy. All you need is a smartphone, tablet, or computer and internet access. Contact their office for an appointment at 877-667-7017. That's 877-667-7017. At Health First, your health is their first concern.
As a community-owned enterprise, the Princeton Electric Plant Board provides services to the people in the Princeton area. One of the services they provide is to make sure the lights are on over our fields and courts for our Caldwell County Tigers. From everyone at the Princeton Electric Plant Board, good luck to all the Caldwell County Tigers and hopes for a safe season. And a big electric roar to their Tigers, Preston Burrell, Addie Vinson, and Lily Horde.
Fortner Gas Company has been serving the propane needs of Western Kentucky for 70 years. You'll find offices in Princeton and Cadiz. They're your local and family-owned propane supplier. Browse their website to discover the many services and products available. You can shop in person or online, and they can answer any and all questions in person or on the phone. If they're already your propane supplier, they say thank you. If they're not, they would love to be. Fortner Gas Company, a family tradition of service since 1951.
It's Kelly Capps with Farmers Bank. Buying a home can be stressful, and I'm sure you have many questions like, what's a good rate? What type of loan is right for me? I'm here to walk you through the process. Whether you're buying your first home, downsizing, or looking to upgrade, Farmers Bank has the options for you. We offer rural housing, VA loans, and so much more. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to give me a call, or you can apply online at yournxtbank.com. Farmers Bank and Trust Company, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Life is filled with moments. Moments we share with those we love, worry about, and strive to protect the most. At Woodman Life, we provide life insurance and retirement products to help protect you and your family so that you can enjoy all the moments to come.
This is Josh Ray, your local Woodman Life agent. Come see us at 1009 West Main Street or give us a call at 365-6111.
Certain eligibility and age restrictions apply. Woodman of the World Life Insurance Society, Omaha, Nebraska.
This Saturday.
Hot! Yes! Touchdown, Kentucky!
It's the Citrus Bowl. Coach Stoops and the Cats are Orlando bound.
Let's go get this!
Iowa Hawkeyes and your Kentucky Wildcats.
The Wildcats!
The Wildcats battle with the Iowa Hawkeyes Saturday. Airtime is at 10 a.m.
on 106.5 WKDZ.
Bradley Furniture wishes all the Tigers good luck this season.
Welcome back to the Cab at the half. Arlington with a two-point lead over Caldwell County, 26-24. Time now to get underway on the Travis Construction and Concrete Halftime Show. Travis Construction and Concrete for all of your construction and concrete needs, as well as remodels, decorative concrete, basements, walls, foundations, porches, driveways, you name it. It's Travis Construction and Concrete. Here's to building a successful year from your friends at Travis Construction and Concrete. Caldwell County led by three after one quarter of play, 15-12, and then outscored by five here in the second quarter as Arlington takes a lead to the locker room, 26-24, a game where the biggest lead of the half has been 8 points that early on by Arlington in the first quarter. Caldwell County boys and girls back in action tomorrow in the West Kentucky Hoops Classic. The Lady Tigers will take the floor against the Lyon County Lady Lions at 3:30 tomorrow. We'll have the air time on that one, hopefully around 3 to 3:30 in that one. And then the Caldwell County boys will take on Lyon County tomorrow night in one that everybody around here has been looking forward to, as it'll put on the floor Jabrion Spikes and Travis Perry in that matchup tomorrow night in the next to the last game of the West Kentucky Hoops Classic. 14 games in 2 days here at the Cab, and getting to be a great get-together each Christmas season here at the Cab. Time now for the stats of the first half, brought to you by Ackridge Farm Supply Ace Hardware, a fourth-generation family business. Ackridge Farm Supply has been providing high-quality goods and services to West Kentucky farmers and homeowners since 1933. Now with stores in Fredonia and Eddyville to serve all of your needs. And for those stats, here's Bob Hayes.
Thank you, Dennis. Score at the end of one quarter of play tonight here at the Cab. Caldwell County led Arlington 15-12. Arlington outscores the Tigers in the second quarter 14-9, erasing that three-point lead, and they now have taken a two-point lead here at halftime 26-24. For the Tigers, led in the first half by Javion Spikes with 13 points. He has 6 2-point field goals, 1 out of 4 from the charity stripe for his 13 points, 5 points for Colin Whittington on a 2-point field goal and a 3-point field goal, 2 points for Carter Whittington on a field goal, 2 points for Xavier Bumpus on a 2-for-2 at the free throw line, and 2 points for D-Man Thompson on a field goal. Excuse me while I get this frog out of my throat. Again, Caldwell County not shooting well at the free throw line. We're 3 out of 8, and it's one of those things where we've been cold, and I'll go over the shooting stats here shortly. For Arlington, Arlington led in the first half by Carl Burrows Jr. with 8 points as a 2-point field goal, 2 3-pointers for his 8 points, 7 points for Aiden Moskovitz, 2 2-point field goals, 1 3-pointer, 7 points, 2 points for Randy White Jr. on a field goal, 2 points for Aiden Ludwig on a 2-point field goal, 1 point for Monazer on 1 out of 2 from the free throw line, and 1 point for Andrew Ellis, 1 for 2 at the free throw line. Not much better shooting by Arlington from the free throw line. They're 2 out of 6. So free throw shooting here in the first half, not very good. In the shooting for the Arlington Tigers, they are 10 out of 22 from the floor, shooting the 45.5%. 3-point field goals, they're 4 out of 8 for 50%. So that's kind of the tail of the tape here in the first half. Caldwell County, 10 out of 29 from the floor, 34.5, and only 1 out of 10 from the three-point arc, 10%. So that has to change for the Tigers to want to remain in this ball game. Total rebounds in the first half by Arlington, 16. And by the Tigers, 20. Nobody in really serious foul trouble, although we know there's a player on Arlington's team that we don't know who drew that foul when the scoreboard messed up. So Caldwell County with 6 turnovers here in the first half, and Arlington with 9. Dennis, so it's obviously a 2-point game. It's still anybody's game.
Well, you look at a couple of things that could change the outcome of this one. Whichever team starts hitting the free throws obviously has a big edge in that department, because neither team's shooting it very well at the stripe. Caldwell County is going to get better than 1 for 10 and 10% from three-point line. You just know with the shooters we have, that has to turn around somewhat and give Caldwell County a lift somewhere in this game. You don't expect that trend to continue for the entire four quarters.
And a lot of those 10-point, three-point shots, we were wide open. Maybe we forced one, at the most two, but we were had wide open looks. They just didn't go down, except for the one by Carter Whittington. Meanwhile, Arlington has 4 threes tonight to 1 3 for the Tigers.
And you think Caldwell County is doing a great job also on the board. Much taller team in Arlington, as they have played all three of their 6'5 kids, also a 6'4 kid. So I think Caldwell County is doing a very good job on the boards.
Yeah, Arlington is, Dennis, correct me if I'm wrong, but they've had a couple, three wide open looks at the ball, at the goal, this last one with about 2 seconds to go, and just point blank missing.
Right.
Easy,
little bunnies
easy passes,
underneath.
Yeah.
This could be a bigger lead. That's going to do it for us on the Travis Construction and Concrete Halftime Show. For all of your construction and concrete needs, call Travis Construction and Concrete.
And remind us that the third quarter is brought to us by Cozy Living Interiors and Boutique. It's Christmas time post So get out there and see what Pam may have on sale, trying to reduce her inventory for the first of the year. Cozy Living, everything a home should be.
Call County. 63 days, shopping days left till Christmas.
Exactly. Call County to inbound the ball at side midcourt. For the call, Dennis Stevens.
Thank you, Bob. Carter Whittington will bring it across. 1-2-2 zone by Arlington. Caldwell County in the dark blue uniforms with the gold trim. Arlington in all white. Caldwell works it around the horn. Over to Spikes, top of the key, into the corner. Carter Whittington back to Spikes. Long three on the way. Gets a friendly roll and goes. Little Caesars Pizza three-pointer. Jabrion Spikes. And that equals their entire total on the first half from the three line, Bob.
Yeah, nice looking shot, wide open again, nailed it.
Caldwell, a little better defensive pressure here to open the second half. Spikes on Moskowitz. Now it's going to be Whittington trying to double team, deflected, three on two the other way. Whittington up and in. Carter Whittington, the assist, Colin Whittington. Caldwell County, five quick points out of the gate. 29-26, Caldwell County. Nasser, the big screen on Whittington, ball goes out of bounds. Knocked out by Caldwell County. I think they're going to call a foul.
D-man, yeah. I think D-man just picked up number two.
Moskowitz takes the inbound pass. Just a minute gone, but Caldwell County 5 points in that first minute. Has a three-point lead. Ellis got away with a walk, drives, stripped away. And then losing it again is Bumpus to White. And White on the steal makes it a one-point ball game. Caldwell walks it up against that 1-2-2 zone. They'll push it down to a 3-2 with Burroughs really coming out high on that one. Burroughs and Bumpus battling for a loose ball. Caldwell County calls the timeout quick to save the possession. A 30-second break. We'll be back. Caldwell leads by one.
Because during this extremely difficult time in healthcare, many are afraid to go to the hospital or the doctor's office. Some folks may miss the opportunity to have Penny Royal Hospice help them through the most difficult of times. As a family member, you can refer your loved ones for the additional care needed at end of life without a hospital or doctor's visit. Penny Royal Hospice, it's about living to the fullest.
Fredonia Valley Bank says, go Tigers! Do your best this season and show that Tiger pride. Good luck from Fredonia Valley Bank.
Back here at the Cab, 6:23 to play in the third quarter. Caldwell County scrapping on the floor for the ball. Able to get the timeout, and for the call here, Dennis Stevens.
Thank you, Bob. Jabrion Spikes in the corner, back out front. Colin Whittington now Spikes left wing. Back to Colin. D-man Thompson now right corner. Caldwell County moving the ball well against this zone, looking for somebody to pop in the middle. You've got Bumpus trying to flash. Now Carter Whittington drives. Pump fake up, no good, but he'll draw the foul. Nice first step by Carter Whittington along the baseline. Whittington's going to go to the free throw line for a couple of Goodwin Insurance free throws with 6:02 to go in the third quarter. First free throw off the back of the rim, no good.
We've got to start making these free throws, Dennis.
How many times have we said, Bob, if you ever lose a single-digit game, you probably missed enough free throws to win it. Free throw up, no good. Two misses by Whittington, rebound down to Arlington. As we go under 6 minutes, Colin Whittington with a steal, gets it to Bumpus. Bumpus going to pull it back out as Arlington got back well. Bumpus double-teamed in the corner, gets it to Whittington. Into the corner, Colin Whittington, 4-3. Off the mark, no good. Rebound, Moskowitz. Outlet pass to Burroughs. Burroughs behind the back, runner in the lane, no good. And D-man Thompson, a strong rebound. Back up, Carter Whittington sees the seam, goes up, no good. Ball's going to be last touched by Caldwell County. A lot of contact for no foul on that one as Carter Whittington sandwiched going up for the layup. 5:23, time remaining in the third quarter. Ellis to Moskowitz. Moskowitz drives, kicks it back off Nasser.
Yeah.
Nasser walked. He had some pressure. Nice weak side help by Carter Whittington.
Four turnovers for Arlington here in the second half. Caldwell County with only one.
Carter Whittington to bring it up for Caldwell County. 1-2-2 zone. Into the corner it goes to Spikes. Spikes double team back out to Colin Whittington, over to Spikes. They work it around now inside to Bumpus. Bumpus off the glass and good. Bumpus strong and patient at the same time. Gets the bucket. Moskowitz behind his back. Picked up by Spikes, top of the key. Over to Burroughs, no good on the three. Bumpus, good position for the rebound. Xavi brings it up, dumps it off to Colin Whittington. Back to Bumpus. Bumpus wants to drive into the corner. Carter Whittington for three off the back of the rim. That's been the miss for Caldwell County, Bob. It's been on the back of that rim every time. Knocked away, ball loose on the floor, Spikes up. Turnover Arlington as we get down to 4:15 to go in the third quarter. Inside, Bumpus off the glass and good. Caldwell County's lead now out to five at 33-28. Timeout called by Arlington, and it's a full. They'll talk about it. 4:04 left in the third. Tigers by five. Back after this.
You'll find over 30 years experience to work for you at U-Ride in Princeton. They are hometown proud and ready to serve your vehicle needs from start to finish. And they do it all safely. You'll find variety and quality vehicles along with on-the-lot financing. And of course, you can always apply online at uridesales.com. Stop by or call for an appointment today with one of their friendly sales staff at U-Ride on the Marion Road in Princeton. 270-365-3018. Hometown proud. Go Tigers!
Since opening its doors in 1996 in Hopkinsville, Planters Bank has made a name for itself as an energetic, forward-looking player of the financial services landscape. Contributing to their success is the flexibility afforded by being well-capitalized, locally owned, and responsibly managed. Today, 25 years later, Planters Bank has offices serving Hopkinsville, Western Kentucky, and Clarksville, Tennessee. Looking forward to the next 25 years. Planters Bank. Expect great things.
Black Patch Grill says, go Tigers. Good luck this season.
Back here at the cab, Arlington inbound it, bringing the length of the floor. Caldwell County with a five-point lead. And for the call, my friend Dennis Stevens.
Thank you, Bob. Arlington gets it in play. Moskowitz met at midcourt by Jabrion Spikes. Over to Ellis. Moskowitz now double-teamed in the corner. Gets it back to Ellis. Give and go back to Moskowitz in the corner. It goes, and three-pointer is good by Carl Burroughs Jr. 33-31, Caldwell County with the lead. Arlington picks up at midcourt. Underneath, Bumpus, strong up, blocked. Ellis back the other way for Arlington, drives it himself off the front of the rim, no good, bad angle. And D-man Thompson with the rebound. He gives it to Spikes. Spikes goes into the corner, Colin Whittington for three, good. Little Caesars Pizza three by Colin Whittington. And Bob, you knew that three-point percentage had to break off of that 10% mark from the first half. Ball deflected as they try to go inside. Instead, it's going to be Ellis, right wing for three, and that one's good. Both teams trading threes as we have 3 minutes left in the third quarter. 36-34 is the score. Caldwell ahead by two. D-man Thompson, top of the key. They'll work it into the corner to Isaiah Joyner into the ball game for Carter Whittington. Spikes, long three, in, took a big roll, came out, dropped back in. College level three, Jabrion Spikes. Now ball loose on the floor. A three on the way is good by Ellis. Neither team very good on the three in the first half, and now trading threes. The last four shots have been threes, 39-34.
A shooting exhibition is broken out here.
Yeah. Spikes dribbling in off the screen from Bumpus into the corner, Thompson to Joyner, back to Spikes. They're going to come out and meet Spikes a little bit farther out. Now Spikes drives, gets up, and puts it in.
And that's what happens when you come out to meet him. He goes right past you.
Spikes can get up and hang in the air better than anybody we've seen in some time in a Caldwell uniform. Stayed up long enough to get that one, just finger rolled it over the front of the rim. Another three on the way, no good. Ludwig with the rebound for Arlington. This one back and forth, a minute 35 to go in the third quarter. Caldwell still up by two at 41-39. Spikes drives that one. Bad pass looking for Bumpus off the mark. Ludwig on the other end, an easy bucket as Arlington had the numbers. Three on one back, tied at 41 now. Turnovers costly when the game is this close. This one's been nip and tuck the whole way. Arlington an early 8-point lead. But since then, Bob, I don't think anybody's had much more than five.
I don't think so either.
Misses the layup. Quick outlet pass to Moskovitz. Up, no good. Misses the bunny. Goes out of bounds off of Isaiah Joyner,
who hustled back to prevent that rebound shot from going in.
Great hustle by Isaiah Joyner. Xavier Bumpus comes out of the ball game for Caldwell County, and Carter Whittington back in. Also into the ball game, big Luke McBride for Arlington. Bad inbounds pass by Arlington. Caldwell County had the numbers back. Joyner is reached in on by number 11, Carl Burrows. Team second. Not a lot of fouls in this basketball game. Only the second on Arlington, one on Caldwell this half.
Just about the end of third quarter here.
45 seconds left in the quarter. Caldwell County looks like they may be looking at running the clock down for one shot. We'll see who pops open. Spikes on the bench. No, excuse me, Spikes is in that far corner. Caldwell County holds it. Arlington content to stay back. Now they're going to bring Simmons out to try to push the pressure and start the count. Colin Whittington gets it back to Carter. 20 seconds left in the quarter. Whittington spin move back to Colin. Colin to Carter. Caldwell works it out front over to Spikes. Spikes has 10 seconds to Colin Whittington. Colin drives, has it blocked. Joyner gets it in the lane, has to go back up, off the glass, no good. And the horn sounds, a good one here in the West Kentucky Hoops Classic. Caldwell 41, Arlington 41, back after this.
Life is filled with moments. Moments we share with those we love, worry about, and strive to protect the most. At Woodman Life, we provide life insurance and retirement products to help protect you and your family so that you can enjoy all the moments to come.
This is Josh Ray, your local Woodman Life agent. Come see us at 1009 West Main Street or give us a call at 365-6111.
Certain eligibility and age restrictions apply. Woodman of the World Life Insurance Society, Omaha, Nebraska.
Since opening its doors in 1996 in Hopkinsville, Planters Bank has made a name for itself as an energetic, forward-looking player of the financial services landscape. Contributing to their success is the flexibility afforded by being well-capitalized, locally owned, and responsibly managed. Today, 25 years later, Planters Bank has offices serving Hopkinsville, Western Kentucky, and Clarksville, Tennessee. Looking forward to the next 25 years. Planters Bank. Expect great things.
Back here at the Cab, 8 minutes remaining in the game. Fourth quarter about to start, brought to us by Cozy Living Interiors and Boutique, located next to the bowling alley. Stop in and see beautiful furniture, baby furniture, gifts, and registry. Cozy Living, everything a home should be. And for the call here in the fourth quarter, my friend Dennis Stevens.
Thank you, Bob. It's Moskovitz with the basketball for Arlington. Hands it off to Simmons, back to Moskovitz. Big Luke McBride into the ball game for Arlington. Shot by Moskovitz off the glass, no good. Foul called on the play. Foul's going to be on Colin Whittington. That'll put Aiden Moskovitz at the line for Arlington.
Not been to the line yet tonight.
First one rolls off the side, no good. Joyner out. Bump us in for Caldwell County. Tied at 41 as we get underway here in the fourth quarter. Moskovitz's second is good. And the lead back to Arlington, 42-41. Carter Whittington at the point for Caldwell County. Gets it to his brother Colin on the wing. He'll pass it around the top. Joyner back to Whittington. 3-2 zone. It's going to be Joyner for three off the mark. Spike, strong rebound up and in, and the foul. Count the bucket as Spikes got the rebound, went back up strong. Caldwell with the lead and a chance to move it to two. Spikes a little struggles at the line tonight. We'll see if he can iron him out here. This one up, rattles out, no good. McBride with the rebound. I think it was Union County. Spikes looked like he couldn't ever miss again in his life and just having all kinds of trouble tonight. Missed by Moskovich, rebounded by Colin Whittington. Whittington pushing it underneath. Spikes and the foul. Great assist. Colin Whittington dribbled in, drew the defense to the top of the circle, or excuse me, the bottom of the circle, and a little dump off one-hand push pass right over to Spikes. Moskovich with his third, four on Arlington. Goodwin Insurance free throw coming up for Jabrion Spikes.
I've been watching him, Dennis. I think he shoots a little too flat. There's Arch.
There it is, and there it goes in. Good call on that one, Bob. Caldwell with a little backcourt zone pressure. Arlington breaks it, gets it into the front court. It's Simmons out front. 46-42 Tigers. 7 minutes to go in the ballgame. And it was a give and go. Simmons went to Burroughs. Burroughs brought it right back, but Simmons broke to the goal.
I think it dislodged the shrimp down here at the scorer's table. That's seven turnovers for Arlington here in the second half. Caldwell County with only two.
Joyner and Carter Whittington playing a little pitch and catch out front. 2-3 zone now by Arlington. Carter Whittington with it back on the wing to Spikes. Spikes looks it over. Into the corner, wide open three on the way. That one partially blocked by a big Nasser. As Joyner had an open three, back tap is going to be called as a foul on Colin Whittington, I do believe.
He's picked up his third one, I think, Dennis. Yes.
First Tiger with three fouls. 6:14, or excuse me, 6:17 to go in the fourth quarter. 46-42, Caldwell County with the lead. Tigers in man-to-man defense. Underneath, Nasser off the glass, no good. Nasser gets his own rebound, puts it back in off the glass. And it's a two-point ball game as we go under 6 minutes to play. Carter Whittington into the trap out front, gets it to Colin. Colin drives, dumps it off to Spikes. Spikes trying to dribble out of trouble, goes up, no good, off the glass and in for his rebound and put back. Jabrion Spikes really working the boards well. Underneath, Nasser, easy bucket, nice assist from Moskovitz. Bob, how long has it been since either team got more than five ahead? This one has been close since the first quarter.
It's definitely going down to the wire, Dennis. It's
Spikes amongst four people off the glass and good. Farmers Bank shot, Jabrion Spikes. Farmers Bank and Trust Company, home of the Tiger debit card, the card that gives back to future athletes of Caldwell County.
Jabrion with 30 points now in the game, Dennis.
Coach K talking about how Nasser is getting open for the last couple of trips, really getting on the guys. You got to have the weak side help, and a foul call. That one's going to be a tough one.
That's on Colin Whittington, his fourth.
So Whittington will have to play smart the last 5:04 of this one. Nasser to put it in play. Gets it right back. Dumps it off. Moskovitz off the glass and in. Arlington really having a lot of success down low. Both sides of the lane with Moskovitz and Nasser. Caldwell back in the front court. Gets the ball in the hands of Jabrion Spikes. Spikes looks it over. Drives. Dumps it off. Joyner, excuse me, that was Bumpus up with the miss. but Spikes with the rebound for his 32nd point, 32 of Caldwell's 52, and the lead back at four.
I'm going to take the human highlight reel off of Blake and give it to Jabrion.
Shot blocked by Carter Whittington on number 11, Burroughs. Burroughs gets it back. He's going to try a three. No good. Nasser tapped it to Arlington's Burroughs, but out of bounds. Joyner into the ball game, and Colin Whittington's going to come out. I don't know how long Coach K will keep him over there. Probably not much more than 2 minutes, if that much. Timeout called by Arlington, a 30-second timeout. We'll take a quick break and be back. Tigers by four with 4:11 left.
You'll find over 30 years' experience to work for you at U-Ride in Princeton. They are hometown proud and ready to serve your vehicle needs from start to finish, and they do it all safely. You'll find variety and quality vehicles along with on-the-lot financing. And, of course, you can always apply online at uridesales.com. Stop by or call for an appointment today with one of their friendly sales staff at U-Ride on the Marion Road in Princeton, 270-365-3018. Hometown proud. Go Tigers!
Raider Auction Company is excited to cheer on all the Tiger athletes this season. Go Tigers from Raider Auction Company.
Back at the Cav, 4 minutes, 11 seconds to play. Caldwell County nursing a four-point lead. Caldwell County to inbound the ball, bring it the length of the floor, and for the call, Dennis Stevens.
Thank you, Bob. Arlington going to bring some backcourt pressure, so Carter Whittington had to go back. Now it has it stolen away. Three on one. Arlington Moskowitz misses the bunny. And, Bob, that's probably at least five of those that Arlington has missed tonight from point blank. Under 4 minutes to go, 52-48 Tigers. Spikes with the basketball, pulls up just inside the free throw line. Shot no good. Rebound comes down to Arlington and Burroughs into the corner to White. White drives baseline off the glass and in. Caldwell County inbounds to D-man Thompson. He'll find Carter Whittington. Colin Whittington on the bench with four fouls. Out to Joyner to Spikes. Into the corner, it goes to Bumpus. Underneath, Joyner off the glass. Basket and the foul. Protecting the ball well with that left hand. And he'll go to the stripe to try to make it a three-point play.
Nice move that time. Nice pass.
So Joyner at the line. 3:25 left in the ball game. Free throw by Joyner is good. 5-point lead now for Caldwell County. Moskowitz up the court for Arlington. He'll go right side, guarded by Spikes. Nasser trying to set the screen. Moskowitz, long three off the back of the rim, no good. Joyner high for the rebound. And Spikes will bring it up against pressure. Up to Whittington. Whittington kicks it over. D-man Thompson turned down to three. He's going to drive. A lot of contact. Okay. D-man goes down. No foul called. Nasser comes up with the ball. Moskowitz the other way. No good. But it's Nasser on the rebound. I can't believe no call on D-man Thompson as he went for the layup. Three-point Tiger lead. Bumpus with the basketball to Joyner. Joyner to Spikes. Spikes, spin move, has it taken away on the double team. Up to Nasser. Nice hustle play from a trailing Carter Whittington, able to get a hand in front of Nasser as he went up for the layup, knock it out of bounds. That play saved an easy 2 points, Bob.
Absolutely. I mean, fast closing. And the two-minute mark is where I thought maybe you might bring Colin back, but just – He's not on the floor, is he, Colin?
No, he's on the end of the bench down here. 2:26 to go. 55-52. Joyner gets a hand. Excuse me. Bumpus gets a hand on the play.
And it's out off of.
Off of Arlington. You're right. Off of White. Off of R.J. White. Good hustle play by Xavi Bumpus.
9 turnovers in the second half for Arlington. That's been their biggest bugaboo.
Caldwell finds a way to get it to Spikes. Back to Whittington. Whittington with some pressure. Now over to Spikes. Underneath, all alone, up and in. Number 11, Dewey Riley.
Big time to get his first points of the night.
Riley makes it a 5-point game as we go under 2 minutes to play. Foul called on the floor. Little touch foul as Pearls went up for the shot. Riley's first, team fifth. Both teams with five fouls here in the second half. Full timeout called by Arlington. We'll take a break and be back. Caldwell, a five-point lead, just under 2 minutes to play. Back after this.
Trice Hughes has been serving Western Kentucky for over 60 years. Their experienced sales force, ASE certified techs, and all the friendly folks at Trice Hughes have worked to become your family's exclusive automotive dealer. The home team that's kept our family safe on the road for generations. From work to play and everything in between, your home team has what you need. Stop by and drive the difference. Our home team, Trice Hughes, Highway 91 North in Princeton.
Happy New Year from Pennyryl Electric. Did you know that outage information is right at your fingertips this winter? Pennyryl Electric works hard to ensure that the power stays on. But when something unforeseeable happens, they make it easy for you to stay informed. All you have to do is send a text to 85700. That's 85700. Save Pennyryl Electric in your contacts as 85700 for easy use in the future. May your season be warm and bright. Happy New Year from Pennyryl Electric.
Black Patch Grill says, go Tigers. Good luck this season.
Back at the camp and for the play, here's Dennis Stevens.
Thank you, Bob. Quick turnover by Arlington on the inbounds play as Spikes comes up with it. Sparks guarded by Moskovitz. Into the corner it goes. Three on the way. Bumpus, good. Little Caesars Pizza, three-pointer and a big one. Xavi Bumpus. Biggest Caldwell lead of the night, 60-52. Runner in the lane, good by Burroughs. Quick timeout called by Arlington. We'll see if it's a 30 or a full. Full timeout called back after this on WPKY.
Your local McDonald's wants you to know that they are ready to serve you for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Dine-in or the drive-thru is always open, and they offer curbside pickup service. To avoid the wait in the drive-thru, you can download the McDonald's app and try curbside pickup. Stop in soon and enjoy breakfast, lunch, or dinner at your local McDonald's. Proud to be a part of this community. McDonald's of Princeton, proud supporters of the Caldwell County Tigers.
Hey guys, it's Kelly Capps with Farmers Bank. Buying a home can be stressful, and I'm sure you have many questions like, what's a good rate? What type of loan is right for me? I'm here to walk you through the process. Whether you're buying your first home, downsizing, or looking to upgrade, Farmers Bank has the options for you. We offer rural housing, VA loans, and so much more. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to give me a call, or you can apply online at yournxtbank.com. Farmers Bank and Trust Company, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Community Medical Clinic is excited to cheer on the Tigers all season long. Go Tigers from Community Medical Clinic.
We're back at the cab, minute 27 seconds to play. Caldwell County to inbound it, bringing it the length of the court. For the call, Dennis Stevens.
Thank you, Bob. Tigers up by six. Whittington looks to get the ball in, finds Spikes. Spikes double team, tried to get it over to Carter Whittington and hit on the elbow. We'll see if that's White or Burroughs. It is going to be on White.
His second foul.
Sixth team foul. Caldwell will start shooting on the next foul. A minute 24. Caldwell gets it up to Bumpus. Bumpus loses it out of bounds. No foul called on the play.
He was going too fast and didn't have his head around to know where the defensive man was.
Yeah, bad angle and went out of bounds right in front of the scorer's table. So Arlington with the turnover, 60-54. Caldwell County leads this one. Three on the way from Ellis, way short. Colin Whittington back in the game with the rebound. Whittington hit across the arm, has it stolen away, and a three is good by number 11, Burroughs. 8-point lead down to three. Caldwell gets it up to Bumpus. Bumpus down to Riley. Riley's going to find Whittington, has it stolen away. Whittington gets it back. Good heads-up play by Carter Whittington. Timeout called by Coach K to save that possession. 51.6 seconds left. Caldwell County leads by three, back in 30 seconds on WPKY.
Learn about your heart health with a simple scan. The Cardiology Clinic at Caldwell Medical Center features a
highly trained team of heart health specialists and years of experience in cardiac health and wellness. Our specialists provide a wide range of cardiac-specific services, offering coronary artery calcium testing, stress test, echocardiograms, sleep studies, and more, all right here close to home. To schedule an appointment, visit CaldwellMedical.com.
Fredonia Valley Bank says, go Tigers! Best this season and show that Tiger pride. Good luck from Fredonia Valley Bank.
Back at the Cab, 51.6 seconds to play. Caldwell County holding a three-point lead. Caldwell County in possession of the basketball. And one thing we don't need now, Dennis, are turnovers.
Yeah, you got to stay away from those. You have to take care of the basketball because Caldwell County had an eight-point lead less than a minute ago. Now that's eroded down to just a one-possession game, 60-57 Tigers. Possession arrow is in favor of Caldwell County at this point. We'll see what Coach K drew up out of the timeout as Carter Whittington will take it out of bounds.
And Colin is back in the game.
Carter Whittington looking to get it in. Finds his brother Colin, back to Carter. Carter double-teamed and stolen away. Pass, he tried to thread a needle down to Riley. It's Arlington back the other way. Baseline drive, dump off Ellis, up and in. 1 point game, 35 seconds left. Caldwell gets it in the hands of Spikes. Back to Whittington, over to Jabrion. Jabrion has Moskovich reach in as Jabrion tried to turn the corner and get it into the front court.
Arlington foul number 14, Moskovich.
1-1 coming up for Jabrion Spikes. Biggest Goodwin Insurance free throws of the ball game as Spikes will have the one and the bonus.
We need to see that little arch on it, Jabrion.
This one up and good. Bob, you're exactly right. Early on, it was just a little bit of a line drive to him. And he's arched the last two. Really looks good on the stroke now. 61-59. Spikes' second free throw, good. 3-point lead for the Tigers. 26 seconds left to go in the ball game. Moskovitz out front, guarded by Spikes. Three on the way is good. Moskovitz. Caldwell County, 15 seconds left on the clock. They get it in to Bumpus, over to Spikes. Spikes with 8 seconds. Still in the backcourt, Spikes up the court, tosses it over. Three on the way from Bumpus, off the glass, no good. Spikes goes up for the rebound shot. No call on the foul, and we are going to overtime. At the end of regulation, Caldwell 62, Arlington 62. Back after this on WPKY.
Enjoy your favorite Mexican food at La Potosina Mexican Restaurant. They're open 7 days a week from 11 a.m. until 9 p.m., offering up all your favorite authentic Mexican dishes for lunch and dinner. Now you pair your favorite meal with your favorite margarita. Enjoy dining in or call in for carryout. Call 270-365-3848 to place your order. They appreciate your business and are ready to serve you in a safe atmosphere. That's La Potosina Mexican Restaurant,
Princeton and Marion.
Hello, this is Brad Harrelson with First Southern National Bank. There is little doubt that many are facing financial hardships in our country today. The statistics can be startling to look at, with as many as 70% of Americans having less than $1,000 saved for emergencies. While it can be easy to point fingers, the truth of the matter is that many folks lack the basic financial knowledge to avoid these pitfalls. To meet this need, First Southern has provided financial literacy resources so that the people of our communities can be better equipped to face the financial challenges life throws their way. We invite you to explore the Financial Literacy Resource Center at FSMB.net. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Good luck to all our Tiger athletes this season from the Armory Gun Shop. Go Tigers! Give it your all.
We're back here at the Cab. Overtime about to commence.
Bob, turnover is a big factor in that last minute and a half for Caldwell County as they saw an 8-point lead disappear. Caldwell controls the overtime tip. Carter Whittington with the basketball. Both Whittingtons, Jabrion Spikes, Dewey Riley, and Isaiah Joyner on the court for Caldwell County. Spikes, spin move in the lane, kicks it out. Open three from the corner for Whittington, rims out. Rebound to Burroughs. Burroughs quickly back the other way, drives over to Moskovitz. Open three from the left side off the back of the rim, no good. Colin Whittington with a strong rebound. Gets it to Carter. Carter into the front court. Both teams still running. Carter Whittington up and no good. Spikes rebound, no good. Spikes with the tip. Jabrion, another big scoring night and a two-point lead for Caldwell County.
Not just notched his 36th point.
64-62, 1 minute gone in overtime, 3 minutes left. Moskowitz thought about the three over Spikes, instead goes underneath to Ellis. Ellis off the rim, no good. Rebound comes down to Whittington, finds Spikes. Spikes goes to the corner, back out to Colin Whittington, has it ripped away, but a foul called on Moskowitz.
That may be it for him.
Moskowitz hit the big three to tie the game. And that is five, Bob. So Aiden Moskowitz out of the ball game.
They lose an outstanding player, great shooter.
Caldwell County bringing in some rebounding help, as it's going to be Xavier Bumpus and D-Man Thompson checking in at the line for one, and the bonus is going to be Colin Whittington.
Colin not been to the line yet tonight.
First one good. Whittington gets the bonus. Big Goodwin Insurance free throws the rest of the way in this one. Arlington still not in the bonus. Second free throw good. 4 point lead, 2:50 left in regulation, or excuse me, in the first overtime. Simmons with the basketball now for Arlington. Goes off a screen, drives, Burrows for three, no good. Ball loose on the floor, D-Man Thompson, big outlet pass, up and in. Colin Whittington, a little snowbird back, and Whittington with the bucket, 68-62. Tigers' biggest lead of the second half, and maybe biggest lead of the, no, 8 points was the biggest lead of the game.
Foul just been called on Carter Whittington, his second.
Combo fouls on number five, Carter Whittington, his second, team six. From this point on,
both teams will be shooting free throws the rest of the way in this one, 2:16. Taking it out of bounds is going to be Andrew Ellis. Ellis looking for somebody to come to the ball. Long pass over to Burrows. Burrows wants to drive, crossover dribble, runner in the lane, no good. Nasser over the back, that had to be. Great position, D-Man Thompson. And they're going to call Thompson?
No.
No, okay.
Yeah.
Foul on Nasser. Nasser is a tall kid, goes 6'5", but D-Man Thompson, excellent position underneath on the rebound. And that will put Thompson at the line for a 1-1.
D-Man with 2 points so far tonight. Not yet been to the line.
Goodwin Insurance sponsors our free throws. Contact Goodwin Insurance for a free quote. D-Man Thompson, first one, rims out. Rebound down to Ellis. 2:06 left in the overtime. Ellis drives, has it knocked loose from behind. Back is Spikes, Spikes up and in. Good recognition from Whittington. And now that lead matches the Tigers' biggest here of the second half at 8 points. But D-Man Thompson reaches in on R.J. White.
D-Man's picked up his third. Now Arlington will be in the bonus.
And one thing you don't want is that clock stopped while Arlington has a chance to chip into that lead. R.J. White at the line for Arlington.
Been there twice tonight, missed both of them.
First free throw is no good. Rebound, Colin Whittington. Gets it to Spikes, back to Whittington. Over to his brother Carter. Carter across half court. Pulls up to Colin Whittington. Now he finds Spikes. Spikes drives into the corner. He's going to be fouled. Even though he had struggles in the first half at the line, that's who Caldwell wants the ball in the hands of. Sparks will step to the line. You're listening to Tiger Basketball on WPKY Princeton. Jabrion Spikes.
Nailed his last three in a row. There's the arch.
And good. Another monster night offensively for Jabrion Spikes. Spikes
now
gets set
for
his second.
Points, Dennis. shooting for 42.
And good, and a 10-point lead for Caldwell County. Full timeout called by the Tiger bench. We'll take a break and be back. Tigers up by 10 with 1:31 left. Back after this.
Fortner Gas Company has been serving the propane needs of Western Kentucky for 70 years. You'll find offices in Princeton and Cadiz. They're your local and family-owned propane supplier. Browse their website to discover the many services and products available. You can shop in person or online, and they can answer any and all questions in person or on the phone. If they're already your propane supplier, they say thank you. If they're not, they would love to be. Fortner Gas Company, a family tradition of service since 1951.
Learn about your heart health with a simple scan. The Cardiology Clinic at Caldwell Medical Center features a highly trained team of heart health specialists and years of experience in cardiac health and wellness. Our specialists provide a wide range of cardiac-specific services, offering coronary artery calcium testing, stress test, echocardiograms, sleep studies, and more, all right here close to home. To schedule an appointment, visit CaldwellMedical.com.
And we're back at the cab, minute 31 to play. Caldwell County up by 10. Arlington will bring it the length of the floor under some pressure. And for the call, Dennis Stevens.
Thank you, Bob. They get it in to Burroughs. Burroughs, let's go with a three. Quick one. It's good. And a quick timeout called by Arlington. It's going to be a full timeout. Back in 1 minute. Tigers by 7.
Happy New Year from Pennyryle Electric. Did you know that outage information is right at your fingertips this winter? Pennyryle Electric works hard to ensure that the power stays on. But when something unforeseeable happens, they make it easy for you to stay informed. All you have to do is send a text to 85700. That's 85700. Save Pennyryle Electric in your contacts as 85700 for easy use in the future. May your season be warm and bright. Happy New Year from Pennyryle Electric.
Your local McDonald's wants you to know that they are ready to serve you for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Dine-in or the drive-thru is always open, and they offer curbside pickup service. To avoid the wait in the drive-thru, you can download the McDonald's app and try curbside pickup. Stop in soon and enjoy breakfast, lunch, or dinner at your local McDonald's. Proud to be a part of this community. McDonald's of Princeton, proud supporters of the Caldwell County Tigers.
And we're back here at the cab. Caldwell County to inbound the ball. Caldwell County up by 7 points here with a minute 25 seconds to play, and we'll inbound the ball. And for the call, Dennis Stevens.
Thank you, Bob. Stay tuned after this one's over. We'll be in the Trilogy Performance Sports postgame show. Colin Whittington looking to get it in to Spikes, and does. Spikes all the way up court. Carter Whittington up, fouled on the play. No call, misses the shot. It's Arlington back the other way. Burroughs, layup is good. 72-67. Thompson has the inbounds pass stolen away. Arlington back up and in with Burroughs. Nasser got a hand on it. A 10-point lead down to 3 now. 72-69. Colin Whittington up to Spikes. Spikes going to take it to the hole, off the glass, and count it, and the foul. Jabrion Spikes. Well into the 40s already point-wise. He'll step to the line for a Goodwin Insurance toss and try to add one to it. Limping off is going to be Zabrion, or excuse me, it's going to be Xavi Bumpus. Into the ball game is going to be Isaiah Joyner. Officials wiping up some moisture on that end as Spikes went to the floor after the foul. 50.1 seconds left, but Bob, we felt pretty good about a minute 11 left with a 10-point lead, but some quick shots and a turnover by Caldwell County. Quick shots by Arlington, and it was down to 3. Now it sets at 5, and Spikes will try to make it 6.
Jabrion with 42 points as we sit here, shooting for 43 and 44.
Or just the one on the make on the shot. Just. So this shot off the back of the rim, no good. 5-point lead, 47 seconds. White pulls up for 3, top of the key, no good. Rebound Arlington. It's going to be blocked, and they're going to say a foul on Isaiah Joyner. which will send V.J. Simmons to the line. Looked like a lot of ball from here. Coach Cash cannot believe that one. First foul on Joyner, but a two-shot foul as Simmons steps to the line for Arlington. First one up and good. An even 41 seconds left in this contest. Unless it goes to a second overtime. Simmons. Good on the second one. One possession ball game. Spikes with the basketball. He'll get it up to Carter Whittington. Whittington to Collin. Collin back to Carter. Collin trying their best to work some time off the clock. Pass stolen away. Coming back the other way is going to be number 12, Simmons. Three on the way from Ellis, no good. Ball loose and a big rebound going up high. Isaiah Joyner. Foul called on the play. 18.4 seconds as Isaiah Joyner will go to the other end for two shots. Third foul on R.J. White, but Bob, big free throws here. Even one will make it a two-point or two-possession ball game.
I hope I don't jinx Isaiah, but he is a really good free throw shooter.
First one up and good. Nothing but net. Two-possession ball game with 18.4 seconds left. 75-71. Second free throw rattles off. Ellis with the rebound. Arlington hustles it up the court. Three on the way. Off the back of the rim. No good. Spikes large for the rebound. Jabrion kind of holds it for a second. He's going to be fouled by White. 7.3 seconds left on the clock.
I believe we can get the cigars out now, Dennis.
Yeah, they can start turning out the lights if it weren't the next to the last game, I guess. Spikes to the line. Two Goodwin Insurance free throws coming his way. Goodwin Insurance, your locally owned independent insurance agency capable of handling all of your insurance needs. First free throw is good. 76-71. This one in overtime. Spikes second free throw off the back of the rim. No good. Nasser with the rebound. Nasser up to Burroughs. Burroughs long three on the way. No good. Nasser had the rebound knocked away. And that's going to do it. In overtime, Caldwell County with a big win. Caldwell County 76, Arlington, Tennessee 71 in overtime. We'll take a quick break. When we come back, we'll get underway on the Trilogy postgame report. That's next on WPKY.
Fortner Gas Company has been serving the propane needs of Western Kentucky for 70 years. You'll find offices in Princeton and Cadiz. They're your local and family-owned propane supplier. Browse their website to discover the many services and products available. You can shop in person or online, and they can answer any and all questions in person or on the phone. If they're already your propane supplier, they say thank you. If they're not, they would love to be. Fortner Gas Company, a family tradition of service since 1951.
Hey guys, it's Kelly Capps with Farmers Bank. Buying a home can be stressful, and I'm sure you have many questions like what's a good rate? What type of loan is right for me? I'm here to walk you through the process. Whether you're buying your first home, downsizing, or looking to upgrade, Farmers Bank has the options for you. We offer rural housing, VA loans, and so much more. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to give me a call, or you can apply online at yournxtbank.com. Farmers Bank and Trust Company, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
KFC Princeton, offering their amazing fried chicken and all the fix-its. You can dine in or call your order for pickup inside or use their convenient drive-thru. Your local KFC is located on the Marion Road in Princeton. Whether you enjoy a quick lunch or take dinner home or maybe take something to a friend in need, they're always ready to help. They're also looking for team members at KFC. Ask about becoming a member of their team. KFC on the Marion Road, where they appreciate your support and they are Princeton strong.
Trice Hughes has been serving Western Kentucky for over 60 years. Their experienced sales force, ASE certified techs, and all the friendly folks at Trice Hughes have worked to become your family's exclusive automotive dealer. The home team that's kept our family safe on the road for generations. From work to play and everything in between, your home team has what you need. Stop by and drive the difference. Our home team, Trice Hughes, Highway 91 North in Princeton.
This is what Kentucky basketball sounds like.
Got it. To raise.
Ball knocked away, stolen.
A night.
Bullseye.
Championship banner.
The road to number 9 lives here.
UK takes on Missouri Wednesday at 4:30. Hear all the coverage on WKDZRadio.com and
on 106.5 WKDZ.
Back to the cab as Caldwell County wins a thriller in overtime over Arlington, Tennessee, 76-71. Time now to get underway on the Trilogy postgame show. Get into shape and feel good at Trilogy Performance Sports. Trilogy is a family-friendly environment that offers a wide range of classes to help you reach all of your fitness and well-being goals. Caldwell County had a nice lead down the stretch, but that one evaporated away. The game went into overtime, but Caldwell County strong in that overtime. Better free throw shooting in the second half, better three-point shooting in the second half, and just a monster night offensively from Jabrion Spikes. And Caldwell County gets their fourth win in a row and five out of their last six as they improve to 6-2 on the season. Arlington, Tennessee drops to 6-4. In their season, Arlington, a team from the Memphis area in Tennessee. Good game as both teams up and down the court. 10 points, the biggest lead of the night for either team. But Jabrion Spikes just playing at a different level of basketball than the start of the season. And Caldwell County able to do some things better in that second half and pull away with a very impressive 76-71 win over a highly rated team out of Arlington, Tennessee. Bob tallying up the totals here as we'll get set for the average stats of the ball game coming up in just a little bit.
I'm ready, Dennis.
All right. For those stats, I'll turn them over to Bob after I tell you that they're brought to you by Ackridge Farm Supply, Ace Hardware, a fourth-generation family business. They've been providing high-quality goods and services to West Kentucky farmers and homeowners since 1933. Now with stores in Princeton and Eddyville to help you serve all of your needs. And for the stats, let's go to Bob Hayes.
Thank you, Dennis. Caldwell County trailed at halftime here at Arlington tonight, 26-24. In the third quarter, Caldwell County outscores Arlington 17-15 to end the third quarter tied at 41. In the fourth period, again, both teams putting up 21 points in the fourth quarter, and the score ends in regulation tied at 62-62. In overtime, Caldwell County with 14 big points. Arlington could only counter with 9, and that brings the final score, as we see here, 76-71. For Caldwell County, led tonight by Jabrion Spikes. Jabrion with 43 points. I have him with 13 rebounds. Just a monster night for Jabrion. Also in double figures, Colin Whittington with 12 points. 9 points for Xavi Bumpus. 4 points for Isaiah Joyner. 4 points for Carter Whittington. 2 points for Dewey Riley. And 2 points for D-Man Thompson, total of 76 points for the Tigers. For Arlington. Arlington led tonight by Carl Burles Jr. with 23 points, 13 points for Aiden Moskovitz, and 9 points for Andrew Ellis, 6 points for Randy White, 6 points for Aiden Ludwig, 7 points for Mo Nazer. Free throw shooting tonight, not very good for the Tigers, 13 out of 25, 52%. And for Arlington, let me figure that out here, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11. They were 5 out of 11, so not much better there for Arlington. I have Arlington with 21 turnovers, Caldwell County with 15, so Arlington hurt themselves many times tonight, Dennis, with turnovers.
Yeah, Arlington did. They came back when they had to at the end of the fourth quarter and made a good run there in overtime, with Caldwell County able to hold on in the overtime. One stat that jumps out to me, Bob, is total rebounds tonight. Caldwell County out-rebounded Arlington by 41-39 total, which kind of surprises me because Arlington had a lot more size than Caldwell County. They had 3 6'5" kids, a 6'4" kid, and Caldwell County pulls down 41 boards, Arlington 39 on the night. So we are watching for Coach K. We'd love to have him come up here in the Trilogy postgame report. We'll take a break and give him a look. But in the final again, it was Caldwell County in overtime over Arlington, Tennessee, 76-71. We'll be back after a break with more on the Trilogy postgame report on WPKY.
Because during this extremely difficult time in healthcare, many are afraid to go to the hospital or the doctor's office. Some folks may miss the opportunity to have Penny Royal Hospice help them through the most difficult of times. As a family member, you can refer your loved ones for the additional care needed at end of life without a hospital or doctor's visit. Penny Royal Hospice, it's about living to the fullest.
KFC Princeton, offering their amazing fried chicken and all the fix-its. You can dine in or call your order for pickup inside or use their convenient drive-thru. Your local KFC is located on the Marion Road in Princeton. Whether you enjoy a quick lunch or take dinner home or maybe take something to a friend in need, they're always ready to help. They're also looking for team members at KFC. Ask about becoming a member of their team. KFC on the Marion Road, where they appreciate your support and they are Princeton strong.
Are you ready for a new adventure? Christian Care Communities is much more than a safe group of buildings for adults age 62 and older. It's about fellowship with others. At Christian Care Communities, our people are our most precious resource.
The people are so nice, and I've never had any trouble with my good old officials here either. When you come here, oh my goodness, you're just pampered. You don't have to get out and do any garden work.
We've made a lot of new friends and get to talk to them and see what's going on with them. So we really enjoy it. I have no regrets whatsoever. When you walk into your front door, your back door, when you move in, you've picked out everything that goes on the inside. Everything is new.
We are about exceeding expectations. Contact Jessica for a tour and to find out more about our move-in specials. Find us on Facebook at Christian Care Communities Hopkinsville and at ChristianCareCommunities.org.
As a community-owned enterprise, the Princeton Electric Plant Board provides services to the people in the Princeton area. One of the services they provide is to make sure the lights are on over our fields and courts for our Caldwell County Tigers. From everyone at the Princeton Electric Plant Board, good luck to all the Caldwell County Tigers and hopes for a safe season. And a big electric roar to their Tigers, Preston Burrell, Addie Vincent, and Lily Horde.
Enjoy your favorite Mexican food at La Potosina Mexican Restaurant. They're open 7 days a week from 11 a.m. until 9 p.m., offering up all your favorite authentic Mexican dishes for lunch and dinner. Now you pair your favorite meal with your favorite margarita. Enjoy dining in or call in for carryout. Call 270-365-3848 to place your order. They appreciate your business and are ready to serve you in a safe atmosphere. That's La Potosina Mexican Restaurant.
Princeton and Marion.
The WPKY News Edge is committed to keep you informed. Each weekday, they'll email you the top news and sports story of the day for free. No subscription fee. To sign up, click on the news tab at WPKYonline.com to sign up today. Sign up and receive these information updates for free to your email inbox. To sign up, click on the news tab at WPKYonline.com.
Welcome back to the Cab as we roll on the Trilogy postgame report. Final here tonight, Caldwell County over Arlington, Tennessee, 76-71. And one more game left in day one of the West Kentucky Hoops Classic. Coming up on the court is Huffman, Alabama, and Webb, Tennessee. That's going to be a great game as it looks to be up and down the court. Bob may stay around and watch just a little bit of that one. But Caldwell County with a big overtime win over Arlington, Tennessee tonight, 76-71. We'll watch for Coach K out of the locker room. Let's go ahead and do our clutch play of the game, Bob, if you'd like. Coleman Auto Parts sponsors that, your hometown Napa Auto Parts dealer. They have tools, equipment, and many other items for heavy-duty trucks, marine, golf cart, and farm. Stop by and see Charles Quinn Coleman and staff at Coleman Auto Parts in Princeton. Napa know-how at its best. And, Bob, for me, the clutch play, we talked about the shooting stats at halftime. Caldwell County 1 out of 10 from the three-point line. I've got to say that an early three by Whittington in that second half kind of set the stage for Caldwell County to break out of that. And then much better free throw shooting from Jabrion Spikes down the stretch. Caldwell County able to win a tough one here tonight in overtime, 76-71.
And Dennis, you're right. We were 1 out of 10 from three-point land in the first half. And in the second half went 4 for 10, shooting 40%, finishing the game 5 out of 20 for 25%. So, again, the shooting percentages in the first half, total field goal percentage for the Tigers, 34.5%. We brought that up to 44.6 to end the game. So pretty good shooting here in the second half, which it certainly enabled the Tigers to win the game and to get ready for tomorrow's encounter with the Lyon County Lions, which should be a whale of a game, Dennis.
Yeah, we're looking forward to both of those as the Lady Tigers and Tigers will both play Lyon County tomorrow here in the West Kentucky Hoops Classic. We'll be on the air somewhere around 3 to 3:30 for that first game between the Lady Tigers and Lady Lions at 3:30. And then Caldwell County will take on Lyon County in the almost the nightcap next to the last game of this get-together tomorrow night. That's a 6:30 tip-off, and we did get Coach K's attention, and he's going to come up and say a few words. Let's take a one-minute break. When we come back, we'll be suited up with Coach K as we close out the Trilogy postgame report after this.
Get the care that you need to stay mentally and physically well from the convenience of your home. Health First Community Health Center is doing their part to help stop the spread. They're now offering telehealth services to keep you healthy at home. Scheduling a virtual visit with your medical or behavioral health provider is easy. All you need is a smartphone, tablet, or computer and internet access. Contact their office for an appointment at 877-667-7017. That's 877-667-7017. At Health First, your health is their first concern.
This is Alan Watts with your Ag Edge, inviting you to join me Monday through Friday at 5:30 a.m. for the WPKY Morning Ag Report. We check in daily with Caldwell County Agriculture Extension Agent Shane Bogle, get the latest from fellow farm broadcaster Max Armstrong, take a look at the latest livestock market reports, hear the latest edition of Traveling the Bluegrass, and check the opening grain market with Hopkins Elevator's Ben Westerfield. That's the Morning Ag Report from your Ag Edge Network on 103.3 FM and 1580 AM WPKY.
Welcome back to the Trilogy postgame report. Get into shape and feel good at Trilogy Performance Sports. We're being joined by Coach Daniel Kukuhiko. He's going to slip on the headphones. Got a little extra company with us tonight. Coach K, thanks for coming up and bringing your support staff up with us.
That's right, my big support staff right here.
So a great game tonight, fun for us to watch. I'm sure it's a little more nerve-wracking to coach, but a good performance by your Tigers tonight, led by a big night from Jabrion Spikes with, 43?
We could not – he played well. We just made enough plays down the stretch to get a win. Coach Brewer does a great job with those guys. Some of those guys can flat out stroke it. And, you know, we lost our head a couple of times in the first half, couldn't make a shot. But I told the guys, I said, listen, as poor as we shot the first half, you're down two because of your defensive effort. Come out in the third quarter, win the first 3 minutes because of our defense. Had a lot of energy coming out. And that was the problem in the first half. We just came out flat, and we never could get the ball going. So we came out second half a lot better, and, you know, we were fortunate to find a win.
And you did find one in overtime tonight, Jabrion Spikes. I thought a cool stat Todd shared with us a while ago, only the 17th time that a Tiger has topped 40 points, and he has two of them in your last three games.
Hey, he can flat out score. I didn't think he had anywhere near 43. I thought he missed some shots in the first half or the second half. You know, he scores in bunches, and that's I'm glad he's wearing blue and gold. We'll say that.
Keep working him at the free throw line too, Coach Gay, because he could really add to his totals there.
He's gonna increase his percentage by at least 20% next game, isn't he?
We got a resounding yes on that.
We did.
Coach K, talk about something. You went into the locker room at halftime only down two. You shot 1 out of 10 from the three-point line. Didn't shoot just a real good amount in that first half from the field. Struggled at the free throw line. But you're still in it with a team that's got a lot of size on you. And a stat that I was impressed with, you out-rebounded this team by two tonight, even with 3 6'5" kids.
We showed a lot of toughness, you know, on the defensive end. We talk a whole lot about defense and, you know, that rebounding the basketball, we're going to be, on most teams we play, we're going to be the smaller team. We play a lot of guards. We don't have a whole lot of bigs that, you know, at the court at one time. So we got to have that toughness factor. And credit to our guys because they bought in on that end of the floor, which, like I said, kept us in the game.
I think D-Man Thompson, Isaiah Joyner, both of those kids came in, blocked out well tonight against a much bigger team from Arlington and did a good job for you. You had a lot of good role play tonight from a lot of different players that came off the bench.
We did. You know, you mentioned Isaiah Joyner came in and got a couple of steals, I think, got a couple of defensive rebounds, and then gets an and one right there off a nice little pass from Xavier. And, you know, those things win games. You know, whether you play for a minute or whether you play for 32, everybody's minute's important. And, you know, like I said, you know, several games ago, the tough thing here is, you know, we've got a 15-man roster over there that can play. They can do a lot of good things. And, you know, any given night could be a number of guys that get called.
Coach, one thing we got to ask you about, everybody's looking forward to tomorrow night. The first meeting, you've got Jabrion on the floor along with Perry for Lyon County. Everybody's looking for that matchup. So tell us your thoughts on that. How do you get by the excitement on that to keep it a team look as you go in against a highly rated Lyon County team?
Well, we're looking at it that way. You know, we're not looking at it as a Perry versus Spikes. We're looking at it as a Tiger versus Lyon. You know, we're a team, and I think our guys buy into us being a team. You know, they're going to come into our gym. They're a really, really good basketball team. They played a tough schedule this year. You know, we've seen almost this exact team the last several years and see them probably for a few more games. But, you know, they're a good team. But I think we're a good team too. I told our guys that, you know, no matter who we're playing, and this is not a line-specific speech, we got to compete for 32 minutes no matter who we're playing. And that's the thing that your Achilles heel is doing that, and then, you know, on the defensive end doing these certain things, when you game plan for a team like Lyon County, you don't have to change a whole lot. You just change your mindset on a little bit on what you're on the personnel.
Coach K, I know it's been a long day for you and obviously for the little one. So you go ahead and take care of her. We appreciate you coming up and looking forward to hearing the comments tomorrow night as Caldwell takes on Lyon County at 6:30 tomorrow night here in the West Kentucky Hoops Classic.
Absolutely. Got to give a shout out to, you know, all the sponsors. I don't have a list in front of me, but I tell you what, this event, it's been a good day in the gym. Both Tiger teams get wins here today, and you know, this does not go on without the support of the community. And I tell you, in the midst of, you know 2 weeks ago, I know you guys know well, what our community went through, to see our community, you know, rally, that's inspiring to this team, to see the resiliency that a lot of our community members are showing. But like I said, this event wouldn't be possible without so many people that are willing to give time, give financially, give up of themselves. And most of them really don't want a whole lot of credit. They just want to support these young men, and we're thankful for that.
Coach K, thank you, and congratulations on a big win over Arlington tonight. And we will talk to you tomorrow night after the Lyon County and Caldwell County game.
Thank you, guys.
Nice game, Daniel.
Coach K joining us here on the Trilogy post-game report. Caldwell, a big win tonight, 76-71 in overtime. And, Bob, I would have liked to keep Coach K here and talk for a long time about that big win because that was impressive. But I think he's got a about a little 3 or 4 year old that's had a long day and ready to get out of the broadcast booth.
It's been a long day, and my throat was kind of wearing down. I may have to bring me some water tomorrow night, Dennis, when I start talking for minutes upon minutes, it really nags me. But tomorrow night should be really, with the Lady Tigers playing Lion King.